WCW Prime is back on the air, along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is Tony Schiavone on this 4th of July week. A lot going on as we head towards Bash at the Beach. As you know, Hulk Hogan and Vader in the cage. Hogan here with comments. Vader in a match. And a lot going on when you talk about the World Tag Team title. Harlem Heat, the champions, but the Nasty Boys and Blue Bloods hot on their heels.
You know, we talked about last week Renegade being on this program, and it being the 4th of July, Hacksaw Duggan in the Prime Cut match of the week. This is going to be an exciting program. I think towards the end, I got a surprise. I'm going to stick some fireworks up Tony's hind end and light him and let him shoot off for the Prime match of the week.
I'd go for that.
Yes, I'd
let's,
like that.
Let's go to the ring. Okay, tag team action. The former World Tag Team Champions open things up here, Dream. The Nasty Boys against Tom Burton and Manny Fernandez. There's molding out of the past.
That's the name out of the past, but it's not the same animal.
No, you're right.
I'll tell you something right here. The Nasty Boys, they got to be a little furious over situations that have happened to him and transpired back here on the Prime this week. My man, Tony Schiavone, brother, we brought it to you last week. It's a wonder last week that the whole show didn't win an Ace Award. You know, one of them Ace Awards or something. Yeah. From the matches... It was great.
You never know. Yours not over
no,
yet.
No, man.
And a knee, and Tom Burton goes down hard to the floor.
I tell you what, Tom Burton must have said something about his mama, because I've never seen him flurry like he did right off the top right there. You know what I mean? He jumped, and then he got a kick from him, so he must have yelled over and said something about his teeth.
Well, I don't know if he did or not, but I do know that they are still very angry about what happened last weekend at the hands of Harlem Heat and the Blue Bloods. And we're going to have some information a little bit later on from Mean Gene in our control center discussing a match that has been signed for Bash of the Beach concerning all three teams.
Boy, what a thing that's going to be. Bash of the Beach, period. California outside. Sunshine. On my shoulder, make me happy. Remember that?
I sure do.
I confronted Bobby Heenan about me eating bales of hay, too.
And what'd he say?
He ran, brother.
I bet he did. Turned his weasel tail and took off. And into the corner, and here he comes. Whoa, the big guy, and that is Jerry Sags running right through Tom Burton. And Burton, I think, is hurt.
Well, he's hurt. You know, we talk so much in situations. We got so much to say. But, wow, look at this, Tony.
Here we go.
Who is that?
The tag team champions of the world. I tell you, it is getting hot for Bash at the Beach time.
Well, I tell you what, you know, anytime they end the building together, you look for fireworks to start right here. It looks like they got a strategy plan that Sherrod said, I'm just going to go out and mark them, put my men in front of them, and let them know what they're looking at. But Nasty Boys can't make a mistake in here, because if they do, oh, what a dreadful situation they would be in.
Head first now. Oh, it is a pit stop. And that will blind you.
Blind you.
Yeah, to do that too. Manny Fernandez gets rocked, and there they go, the World Tag Team Champions. I wouldn't be surprised to see the Blue Bloods come out here and watch as well.
I'll tell you what, you know, that's a situation with all three of them teams to where they want what Harlem Heat's got, but they all want each other. Throw them all together in there. Take the referee out. Put them out the way. Put them inside there. Put some type of barbed wire around them and let them go. Whoa!
Down goes Fernandez to the hands of Jerry Sags, and here's the exchange. And even though they are brawling, rough, rugged, and certainly a lot of times have no method to their madness, they certainly do know how to team tag in and out.
Well, right here, you know, he's going to set him up for the blivet right off the top right here. Watch the power of this thing. Drives his neck and his back and his buckus and everything right down to the mat. Here you go, big blivet off the top. Hooks that leg up. Gets the 1, 2, 3 Nasty Boys. What a holiday.
Where the Blue Blood is.
What, they're on top of the game right here. You see the pit stop. Get the old nose rubbed in there. Ooh, man. And then right here, he nearly takes his head off. Gets him all set up. The Nasty Boys surely are trying to refine this thing, getting itself back together. And right here, the big power slam, the flip it from the top. The Nasty Boys getting the win, the 1, 2, 3. Looking for the World Tag Team title back around them waist. Blue Bloods, Harlem Heat, get ready.
We'll be back right after this.
Romeo, Juliet, let's try it again.
Again?
Art thou bored?
Yeah.
Step into a Slim Jim. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim.
Back on WCW Prime, still to come in this program, Dream, we will have comments from world champion Hulk Hogan as he prepares to do battle against Vader, and Vader will be here as well, as Hogan and Vader are set to square off at the Bash at the Beach, and truly the most dangerous match Hogan has ever signed for. And now, the Pit Bull Craig Pittman against Red Tyler. Speaking of dangerous, take a look at this guy.
Well, he's dangerous because he can break your arm at any time. He possesses so much power and skill and wrestling knowledge, and some say he's one-dimensional because he starts on an arm and he just continues on until he gets it broke. Well, that's the bottom line. I'd like to see him in there, though, as I said in the past, with somebody has a little more repertoire than Mr. Tyler does right here, because I believe he's going to get ready for an old Code Red, and Code Red means one thing, snap, crackle, and pop on that arm. Yeah. You talk about the cage,
yes,
and the Bash at the Beach,
yes.
150, 200,000, 100,000 people roaming the beach waiting on this thing, brother. It's going to be the biggest pay-per-view event in the history of wrestling, bar none.
And I agree with that. And it will be on the beach in Southern California. And we will all be there on pay-per-view on the 16th of this month. And by golly, it's about 2 weeks away now, Dream.
Little dude Scoop, you don't know what you've done. The Beach Boys. Me and the Beach Boys going out to the House of Blues the night before. I'm going to get right. Oh, look at this. Push-up
on the man. Oh, the conditioning that...
I'm going to try that when I get home with my wife. See if I can do that.
The conditioning that the Sarge has gone through, obviously, is top-notch.
I'm talking about just, you know, we train together, exercise and stuff.
Ooh, the gut?
Yeah,
but that one.
Yeah, them blows didn't have... You know, he already got him out on his feet. Them blows were weak. And they were weak, and now he's weak in the knee. Pittman relentless. Look at that. Right on the arm. I tell you what, you know, him and old Hacksaw Duggan ain't got no love lost between them two. That thing had ran a little bit deal. But Hacksaw, yeah, I know, got his mind on other stuff right now.
Absolutely, he does. And, you know, in an unprecedented move, the Pit Bull the other night, a couple of weeks ago at the Great American Bash, wrestled on the pregame show, broke someone's arm, and then agreed to wrestle on the pay-per-view against Hacksaw Jim Duggan, tried to break his arm, and, well, there you go.
Yeah, well, that's a good call. That's what exactly happened. I mean, that was, I can't even comment on that because you said it so clear. But the Prime, we bring it all to you. Old news and new news. We want you up to date out there. My mom needs to know everything. Everything there is. And Tony, you know, Garden, when he set in for you a few weeks ago, he would bring the stuff to her. But my mom said, you know, she had heard all that stuff. She wanted to hear Tony's voice saying really good new stuff, you know.
You talking about gossips and rumor? And
yeah,
and
I
like
got,
that?
Yeah, I know some rumors,
I know you do. And there's the Pit Bull continuing to assault Red Tyler. That's all this has been assault from the bell. And Tyler giving it his all here. He's got to give him an A for effort here.
Yeah.
But too much Pit Bull here.
Yeah, too much. I mean, you know, that's the bottom line. We'll get right back to it. We can talk around the windows and talk around the floors and go around left field or come in here. But the bottom line is this guy can wrestle. He is was a great amateur. He is going to be a great pro. Some say, again, he's one-dimensional. But I'm going to tell you what, he can take an arm and rag it only like the great Andersons did, Ole Anderson especially. Right there. Great move. Ole never had that move.
No. Nope.
The old headbutt in the stomach.
No, but he had the noggin for it, but never did execute it. And now the Code Red. And it's on, Red Tyler. And the bell sounds, and Pitbull still cranking on the arm, will not let go. That's how he broke a man's arm not too long ago. Look at this.
Well, Anderson needs to get in there. You know, Warren ain't going to get it. He needs to drop down there and get him broke because this kid just started his career, could suffer some injury down there. I'm talking about Mr. Tyler suffering injury. Look at that. Look at the intensity here on Mr. Pitbull. Wow. Code Red him, baby.
The Pitbull, your winner. Coming back, a look at what's happened to Kevin Sullivan on Prime. Back at Slamboree in the month of May, Kevin Sullivan unexpectedly, mysterious, left the ring when a mysterious figure appeared in the video wall. And since that time, we understand Sullivan has gone through a transformation of sorts.
Well, you know, Tony, I heard that he was called high up on the mountains of Kilimanjaro, that he was called out into the deepest woods of Keokuk, Iowa. He has been everywhere to find out who is behind this thing, and we're going to see it right now on Prime.
Let's take a look at the transformation of Kevin Sullivan.
Come to me, my son! Follow the darkness!
I hear you, Master!
Orcomania must be stopped!
Master! Master! I hear you! Master! Master! I'm coming!
Come to me, Sullivan!
I hear you!
A little bit further and you hear!
Which way? Master! Master!
Come to me, my son! Sullivan, you have finally arrived. Sullivan, millions and millions of Hulkamaniacs from the cesspools of Beirut to Tokyo, everywhere they race. By the millions per day, going to the battle of the immortal Hulk Hogan. You are the last remaining link to darkness.
I tried to defeat him. Nobody can defeat him. Why do you single me out? I can't defeat him. The red and yellow, they're just growing leaps and bounds. There's millions of Hulkamaniacs, and you expect me to defeat him?
Sullivan! It is known and felt. The warriors are gathering on the four continents and the seven oceans. You, Sullivan, from the dungeon of doom, will lead them, and you will be successful. It is etched in.
Master, what do you mean it's etched in stone?
Come on, Sullivan! The immortal Hogan is already represented in every country and boulevard in the world! His colors are red and yellow! Fly from every mountaintop! It is one final step, my son, one final step that you have got to take.
Master, I don't want to disappoint you. I've told you, nobody can do it. I've tried. Nobody can defeat the immortal Hulk Hogan. Nobody.
Take it, Sullivan! Take the final step! Come to me, my son! You have taken the final step! Taskmaster!
Yes, Father?
All of the knowledge and all of the brain power, you know what is left to be done.
Father, now that you've given me the power, I know what you meant when you said we will crush the immortal Hulk Hogan and all the Hulkamaniacs, because it is etched in stone!
Welcome back to the Prime. WCW Prime, along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. I'm Tony Schiavone, the Blue Bloods, in this matchup to face Gary Jackson and Larry Santa. Let me ask you something, Dream. We were all part of the Great American Bash. A couple of weeks ago, we had the Bash of the Beach. Did the Great American Bash bring back memories to you? Because it was in 1986, at the same event, you became World Heavyweight Champion. Did you think about that when you were at the Great American Bash the other night?
Yeah, you know, sometimes, you know, I don't like to dwell on the past, but when you've been World Heavyweight Champion, you talk about athletes and you're talking about things that you know some about because you have put on a pair of tights and been in there with them and had that blood, sweat, and tears. I do. Sure I do, because the Great American Bash, what a great event that is for pay-per-view, but only matched, not even really matched by this event that we're getting ready to have, Bash at the Beach. I mean, it's almost like a continuation, if you will, of things that have happened, but it's coming to a head in California, out there on the beach. I'm saying Hogan's home field advantage comes into play with this thing, Invader, inside the steel cage.
Well, we kicked off the summer with the Great American Bash in June, and now in 2 weeks, the bashes continue. The Bash at the Beach will be live from Southern California, Huntington Beach, right south of L.A., and it's going to be a lot of fun.
You know, these guys right here, the Blue Bloods, come into play just a little bit. Harlem Heat, Nasty Boy, that situation there with all three of them, I'm telling you, it is just a very volatile situation, if you will. Blue Bloods, wrestlers, stay down on the mat, take care of business, if you will, down there mat-wise. Harlem Heat, Nasty Boys, just go in there clubbering each other.
Mm-hmm. Full arm dragon twist by Regal. Lord Steven Regal with a big uppercut. And you're taking a look at Larry Santo, who's in trouble. The Blue Bloods certainly were involved in the Nasty Boys losing. This is not clubbing.
No,
is it?
Of course it's not clubbing. It's everybody, you knew that.
Yeah, okay, well,
yeah, that was just, they were both
checking on you here.
No, they were both one-fisted. Clubbing is all four-fisted on one person. That's clubbing.
The Blue Bloods were involved in the Nasty Boys losing the World Tag Team belt. And you will find out a little bit later on of a match that we have signed, an unprecedented match. Incredible match that we will have coming up at Bash at the Beach when Mean Gene comes your way in the control center a little bit later on, involving the Blue Bloods, involving the Nasty Boys, and involving the champs, Harlem Heat. And you said last week you thought of all three teams, the best wrestling team certainly is the Blue Bloods.
Yeah, I would say that, you know, but I'm not saying that they're not the world champion, obviously. So the bottom line, Harlem Heat now holds that rank of being the best tag team in the world because of the prestige that goes with it. But these guys right here, they can wrestle with anybody. See the move? Look, hey, wait a minute. Sit down in front. There, I can see better now.
They're out again. Here they are, the World Tag Team Champions, earlier in this program. Checking on the Nasty Boys and now looking at the Blue Bloods as they prepare for the match coming up at Bash at the Beach.
I'll tell you what, don't turn your prime televisions off. You know the Blue Bloods, the Nasty Boys, and Harlem Heat are all in the building. This could be electrifying stuff going on right here on the prime today. Boy, he's turning up a notch. Look at Duke of Earl Bobby over there, taking a look at Sherrod and Harlem Heat.
That's right. He is keeping an eye on the ringside area and keeping an eye inside as Lord Steven has words with his opponent and has forearms for his opponent as well, Gary Jackson, who is now down on the mat.
Look at Sherrod giving instruction right here.
Regal certainly enjoys hurting people and humiliating people. That's his M.O.
Yeah, and look at Earl Bobby. Wow. What is this going to be? Is this a form of the power driver, or is it going to be the English power driver? Nailed him right there. Make that tag. He's in a lot of pain, blues, and agony. Bobby going up to the top.
There he is. Earl Roberts is perched up on top, and here he goes, the Tower of London. Oh, what a move that is.
Oh, man. Look at that. He ain't through with it. Come on, cover him. What's he doing here?
A reverse chin lock and a neck vice. My goodness. Out of that, and quickly, Earl Robert makes a tag, and here comes Regal stomping a man who's obviously down and out.
He got him with that butterfly stomp. Now he hooks him in there, got him again. Look at that, the way he's got him underhooked. There's no escaping this thing. Blue Blood making a statement right here on prime.
Right in front of the Nasty Boys, right in front of the World Tag Team Champions, Harlem Heat, and they were out earlier, and they're not finished. Look at this.
No, man, they are intense. Look at that.
Swinging neck breaker. Regal has the attention of the referee while Bobby. And now Bobby's got the attention of the referee while Regal assaults the man. We're crying out loud.
Yeah, see you later. Get your hat.
Incredible. The demeanor and the attitude and the ability also of Blue Bloods here on Prime as we go to the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Well, I tell you what, Tony, this was a real statement made by the Blue Bloods right here. Harlem Heat come out to watch some of their match as they did. The Nasty Boys are right here. They set him up with this pile driver, and it's not over here, fans. Once he drives his neck into there, he tags Earl Robert, if you will, the Tower of London, and then he puts him in a trestle hold where he's tied up where he can't breathe, he can't talk, he can't move, he can just give up.
In the trestle hold.
Pretzel.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
Trestle is something you wear around the house.
All right, we'll be back with more, including the new World Television Champion on Prime. We are back on WCW Prime along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is Tony Schiavone, and get ready because here he comes, the new World Television Champion led by Jimmy Hart. It's Renegade!
Oh, boy, you talk about exciting. Boy, the fans and the kids around the country here on Prime, they can't wait to see this young man, mysterious as he is. Bottom line, enforcer, no longer World TV Champion. It belongs to the Renegade.
Renegade is a TV champ, and his opponent in this one-fall TV title match will be Mark Starr. This guy's awesome.
Yeah, he is, but he lacks in ability. He makes up with energy. His energy level is as high as it could be.
Mark Starr, who ducked out of the ring when the Renegade made his appearance, ducking out one more time. And you're right about energy. Look at this.
He's going after him right here. He's in the wrong spot. Wait a minute. Timeout. Ain't no timeout here.
Yeah.
Renegade says, here, go in here and see this mat. See what color it is.
Grabbed him by his earlobes and threw him in. And here we go. Mark Starr trying to get a quick start. Oh, too much power there.
You know, Mark Starr's been around Tony a little bit. That could be a situation here where Renegade makes a mistake. Got to be real careful with a guy like this. But so far, he's looking good.
Back body drop. Renegade winning the World Television belt from Arn Anderson. And now he will meet the winner of the Slim Jim Challenge. And that was Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. He'll meet him at the Bash at the Beach, which, of course, is sponsored by Slim Jim as well.
Right here is what I was talking about. He made a mistake right there. Went in there, hair in front of his eyes, couldn't see the turnbuckle. It's like running a red light, brother. And now that he's ripping and tearing and snorting, getting ready, doing something here, looking at his watch. Whoa, watch out, ref. Ref.
Mark Starr, what's the referee looking at?
He's got some tape. He's choking him now.
He had a warning for Jimmy Hart for some unknown reason, enabling Mark Starr to get the tape around the throat. And that may be all Mark Starr can do with this big guy.
Yeah, Mark Starr just throwing caution to the wind, throwing it all out the window, trying to go for a victory. You know what I mean? Upset here would be unbelievable. But Renegade, he's not off his feet, still on his feet, floundering, getting around there, getting ready. Jimmy Hart running around like crazy from the camp of Hulk Hogan comes the Renegade.
Mark Starr, no effect with those punches, but the Renegade wailing away, big right hands, and now the Renegade shooting Mark Starr to the corner. Here he goes!
Oh,
wow, what a move that was!
Oh, he got him right with his buckets.
And he picks him up, power slams him. Wow, the Renegade with some sensational moves.
He did a little flipping and a flopping there, and he come over and his hind end caught him right in the esophagus, knocked the wind out of him. Now off the top, Renegade perched up there. Remember this Iron Anderson?
Whoa. Yes. Obviously, 1, 2, 3, a man who wins again, whose whole body is a weapon.
Feel the power.
What'd you say, Drew?
I said, well. I was excited about that. Sally Good's back this week. She just waved at me. See Jimmy Hart running around there. He's proud of this guy. You know, the whole camp there. He come out of the whole camp. Bottom line, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, Hulk Hogan, Bash at the Beach, we all going to be there. Look at that. Count it, he's 157 feet.
All right, the Renegade, still the TV champ, awaits now Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Drink.
Okay, here you go. Now, you see this flipping and flopping. He uses his hind ears to knock the wind out. He used a power slam to make sure the wind is gone. And then he takes him home. Let's get out of here.
All right, you good fans here in Southern California, absolutely free. The Bash at the Beach. Do remember this date. We're going to be down in Huntington Beach, and it is Sunday, July the 16th, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. They tell me 50 or 60,000 people are going to be on hand for this one. In the big main event, inside a steel cage, WCW heavyweight champ Hulk Hogan with Jimmy Hart outside the cage, but in Hogan's corner, will be facing... We'll be facing 452-pound Vader, a man that, honest to goodness, makes me nervous. But this is your stomping ground.
Yeah, that's right. Vader was born and raised in inner city L.A. So I want all you chumps, all you Hulkamaniacs, to come on down to the sand come on down to the beach and watch me rub Hogan's face in it. Because Hogan, I've chased you from the East Coast and now to the West Coast. There's nowhere else for you to run, brother. Unless you want to go swimming, you're out of room. It will be Vader time. And I grew up in the heat and the sweat of the ghetto. That's right. I can't remember a day that didn't go by that I didn't have to fight for my survival. And I despised the rich kids down on the beach, laying in the sun, driving their new cars.
Wait a minute. You don't need a lot of money to go to the beach. I know that myself. I spend a lot of time there.
Hogan, you get your hind in down to Huntington Beach. They say it's your stomping ground. Well, brother, I grew up not too far from the beach. We're going to find out what time it is forever. Hogan, brother, not only is Vader going to be there, but you're going to see the new Vader. Win, lose, or draw, I promise you, you're going to get
Huntington
the
Beach Sunday, July the 16th, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Bash at the Beach. Hi again, everybody. Gene Okerlund back in the control center. Bash at the Beach, brought to you by Slim Jim. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim. Huntington Beach, California. Sunday, July the 16th, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific. It's Bash at the Beach, available exclusively on pay-per-view. Contractually, WCW Heavyweight Champion Hulk Hogan has now committed to a title defense inside a 15-foot-high steel cage against 452-pound Vader. These two men have had run-in after run-in since late last year at Starrcade. The fact that the title is on the line in a cage match is unprecedented. Again this past week, I caught up with Hulk Hogan, Jimmy Hart, and company, I should point out, down at the beach. Hey, listen, ladies, just a second. You've got the wrong... I'm a friend of Hulk Hogan. Hey, wait a minute.
Hulkamaniacs, leave him alone. Hey, you guys know he's a friend of ours? You're supposed to take care of him. Pamper this brother. Come on.
Wait a minute. Ladies, it's tough for me to
Welcome
be focused.
Into the steel cage, brother.
Wow. Hulk, I gotta tell you something. With this kind of a distraction around, for me to focus on your big cage match with Vader 2 weeks from this Sunday in Huntington Beach, but it's gonna happen at the Bash at the Beach. What's going through you?
Yo, come here, Blondie. You know something, Mean Gene? You think Hulk Hogan was born at night, brother? You know, I've got every type of distraction strategically placed around the ring, brother. The orange bikinis, the yellow bikinis, the red bikinis, the itty bitty teeny weeny. You got
yes,
that right, brother. But the only thing that ain't gonna be itty teeny and weeny, brother, is Hulk Hogan's fist grabbing Vader's face and running into that steel cage. Jimmy Hart, have you ever seen Hulk Hogan more wound up for a world title match, brother?
He's tighter than a tick, Jimmy.
You know me, Gene? The pythons are pumped, baby. The Hulkster is ready. He's ready to the match, Daddy. Vader, I wouldn't want to be in your place for anything in the world, baby.
Showdown is coming up, Hulk Hogan. These fans are behind you here on your own home turf.
Well, you know something, on my own home turf, brother. Sunday, brother, 3 o'clock, July 16th, Bash at the Beach. You know something? These girls not only look good, brother, they're like greyhounds, brother. I take them out every morning, one at a time, and I run them up and down this beach, brother, till their tongues are hanging out. I'm in shape, Mean Gene. So if Vader can't last past the 20 or 30 minute mark, I'm going to take him and I'm going to crack him in two inside the steel cage. And what are you going to do, brother?
Number of reasons why I love going to the beach. The only chance for a swim out of this one is high tide. In other action, 12 to 15 lifeguards are going to surround the ring as the Macho Man, Randy Savage, meets the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, in a return match. If you recall, a couple of weeks ago in Dayton, Ohio, again, Flair going after the Macho Man's father on Father's Day. Speaking of return matches, new U.S. champion Sting defends against Colonel Robert Parker's pride and joy, the Ominous Ming. With the current WCW tag team picture somewhat up in the air, here's a match that could tear the house down. Three tag teams in a triangle match. The Teams, the Nasty Boys, the Blue Bloods, and now the WCW tag team champions, Harlem Heat, with Sister Sherry. By the way, the team that comes out of this one, a winner, will be the tag team champions. Plus, brand spanking new world television champ, The Renegade, with Jimmy Hart, defending against the Slim Jim Challenge winner, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Huntington Beach, California, here we come. It's Bash at the Beach exclusively on pay-per-view, home satellite, and DirecTV. 2 weeks from this Sunday, July the 16th, 7 o'clock Eastern, Hogan and Vader inside a cage for the title. That's part of that incredible card. Call your cable company right now or call Turner Premier. One way or another, join us live from Southern California for the Bash at the Beach.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the Rocky Mountains, weighing 452 pounds, Vader!
Well, here he is, the man who is the number one contender of the world title, the man who has the shot in the cage, and what is going to be, really, the most intense match of the summer. The hottest match we'll ever want to see. All right, let's go back to Dave Pinter.
His opponent from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, 218 pounds, Ricky Lane.
Ricky Lane, not to be confused with the talk show host, set to go against Vader. You know, Dream, the cage match is what Vader wanted. It's what Hogan agreed to. And I don't know, if you go back to Starrcade at the end of last year when Vader attacked Hogan in the dressing room, if you go back to what happened in Las Vegas in the gigantic powerbomb where he powerbombed Hogan through the mat, Hogan got attacked by Vader and Flair at Super Brawl, and then the wild strap match, and Hogan never did beat Vader. It's never happened. It's a man Hogan has never defeated in the cage.
And a lot of people say that it's an undoable thing. Situation is Hulk Hogan going into his backyard, saying, some say home, Philly Bang. Let me tell you about Vader. Vader is a man that went ahead and wanted something done. He put his hands on Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel. He got one of our colleagues and had him nearly to death. He beat on the executive producer, and I'm telling you, fines were levied, but he didn't care. He got what he wanted, and Hogan got it in the place I think he wanted, and that was out there in California. We all gonna be there on the beach, but brother, when they put the cage up and they turn that thing and they make the introductions all there, Hogan has to face the fact that the most awesome power in WCW is a man they call Vader, and it could be maybe an end to the reign of Hulkamania.
Big forearm shots. Hulk Hogan and Vader will collide, and that's going to be a collision. And you can be a part of it. You won't want to miss this one. The only way you can see it is by coming to the beach in Southern California, or better yet, for you fans all around the world that can't go out to California, call your local cable operator, the cable system you're watching right now, and get Bash of the Beach. Don't be left out.
No, right here is picking him up. We know the power bomb right there is coming, the Vader bomb. He got him right there. You know, if you're in Huntington, West Virginia, someplace like that, and you ain't got a beach, get your two-line chest, throw some sand out there, get your no keg, and sit down and buy Bash at the Beach.
The winner of the match is Vader!
Vader, as always, wins matches with such ease. He is absolutely awesome. He's certainly the most dominating figure the sport has ever seen, and he gets Hogan locked in a steel cage. No way out, no way in for anyone else.
Well, I guarantee the stable of Hulk Hogan, the people there are watching this thing right here. You talk about looking at game film and game plans that he has picked up high right here. You see he has ragtagged this kid right here, this Vader bomb boy. He hooks him up, full of him, gets the cover right there. Gonna look at it again. The power and the force. Can Hulk Hogan withstand this attack by the man they call Vader, maybe soon to be the next WCW World Heavyweight Champion?
Certainly he thinks so, but as far as Vader is concerned, he would just as soon end the career of Hulk Hogan and be known as the man that crushed Hulkamania. He has that ability. Your winner is Vader. The prime match coming up next.
Boy, and it's a good one, too.
All right, all-important date is Sunday, July the 16th. We're going to be back in Southern California with an extraordinary event. This one, the Bash at the Beach. And for you folks down in the Huntington Beach area, well, throughout Southern California, the action starts at 3 in the afternoon out at the beach. And, of course, we're going to be live on the air with the main event for that one. Then at 4 o'clock, It is the Bash at the Beach, an extraordinary card, one you'll want to be part of it, and it's all free. No charge. Can you believe that? World Championship Wrestling not charging in there.
Why, Arnie, Bruce, they'll all be watching the Bash at the Beach. And you know what? The Nasty Boys are going to be doing some bashing.
Let's talk about the match, a triangle match involving the Harlem Heat and Sister Sherry, the Blue Bloods, those two tea-sipping Englishmen, and the two of you. Jerry, the winner takes all.
This is a perfect match to take the Los Angeles, me and Nobbs' home, away from home. It's a triangle match, just like you're boxed in that city. Yeah, me and Nobbs are going to settle all scores with the Harlem Heat, with the two Englishmen, the Blue Bloods. And we've been cruising Sunset Strip, Rodeo Drive. We've been anesthetizing the city, pumping that iron, getting ready to take home the gold one more time.
Did you say that Arnold was going to be there?
Yeah, Arnold's going to be there. And you know what? The boys are going to drive down on their hogs and get some of that sea air in their face because there's a hurricane coming to Huntington. And it's in the shape of the Nasty Boys. And it's looking for the Blue Bloods and Harlem Heat in this triangle of terror, winner take all. And the boys are looking to take everything.
Guys, can I ask you one question? Where do you find a good barber in this area?
Hey, anywhere. You go anywhere in L.A. and you'll find the best. That's why the Nasty Boys are taking everybody
Sunday,
out.
July the 16th, down at Huntington Beach, the Bash at the Beach.
Yeah.
Welcome to Prime Match of the Week time. We've got a dandy for you. Yeah, we sure do. Two big men this week. Almost there?
Yes, sir.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan and Big Bubba should be a collision between two big, powerful men, Dream.
I have looked around to different types of prime cut sounds. And the other day when I was easing by Tony's house late at night, I think I came up with the prime cut move of the week. And here's what it sounds like outside a Tony's house. I don't know what Tony, I don't know his Lord, but this is the way it sounds. I think that was Lord.
I don't remember that sound, but then you never know. Prime Match of the Week time on Prime.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature confrontation, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Cobb County, Georgia, weighing 337 pounds, Big Bubba Rogers.
Now, this has been a program of big and bad. We saw Vader earlier. Here's another big and bad one, Big Bubba.
It's a prime match of the week, right here, prime cut. We talked about Big Bubba Rogers. Wow, he's an awesome folk. We'll have to reckon with here.
All right, Big Bubba in the ring, and we go back to Gary Michael Capetta for the next intro.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, he's from Plains Falls, New York, weighing 287 pounds, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Well, by golly, Jim, we are around the 4th of July as we speak, and why not have Hacksaw Jim Duggan?
That's right, you talk about representing America, right here, the American flag, the old tuba ball. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Big Bubba, this prime match of the week. This is going to be a good one. I think it's going to start off with 55 flying.
This, of course, being the 4th of July week all across America, 2 weeks out from Bash at the Beach. And Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Oh, yeah. And Big Bubba. Boy, Big Bubba's focused.
I'll tell you what, Mr. Duggan better be focused, too, because... Wow.
Whoa.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Hey,
oh. All right, let's get back on this match here.
Did you see that?
Yes, I did.
That was Sally Gooden's sister.
Good. I'm glad you got a sister.
Yes, sir.
We need to go talk to them after this match is over.
I imagine we will. I'll say, this is Sally. This is Tony Schiavone, the ace. She loved that when I say the ace.
The ace,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, 4th of July weekend, let's do it. The week of, here we go.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan and Big Bubba. Two men who are very similar in styles in that they are very big, very strong, very powerful, and like to slug it out. And give Bubba a lot of credit. He has stayed back. He's been very, very low-key during this Hacksaw 4th of July type celebration.
Yeah, I tell you, but he's been thinking about what he's going to do to him, and now that bell rung,
and the flag that the two before put down. Now they got to get it on. Boy, this place is ringing right here with USA. Make you feel good to be America.
All right, match of the week is underway, and we got a great one. Duggan and Bubba. They finally hook up. The full-arm dragon twist into a wrist lock.
Yeah, Bubba went right to it there. You know, took control of the situation right off the bat. While Hacksaw Duggan was parading around there, you know, with that flag and that two before, he was thinking of his mental game plan, and he went ahead and jumped in on him right here quick.
Is what game plan?
Mental game plan.
Mental game plan.
Mental game plan. You got to have that. There's a game plan and a mental game plan. I think with Sally Gooden, it's just a game plan. It ain't nothing mental about it.
We don't have one yet.
We will.
Yanking in on the arm. And Bubba goes to the ropes to try to get away from Duggan. And Duggan, little suspender snap that time.
Popped his suspender.
Well, that's what you get for wearing them.
Well, it just irritates you a little bit, you know.
Fact is, Duggan loves to have a good time in the ring. And fans have a great time when Duggan is in the ring. They can really relate to him. He's the blue-collar champion.
Yes, he is. He's right there. Look at this. A big old Tesla screen. Give me wheel.
Oh. Boom.
Good uppercut there by Bubba.
That's what you don't want to do, getting too close to Bubba, because this is what will happen. The big guy. The powerhouse.
Boom. Here's one back for you. You gave me one, I'll give you two.
Bubba goes outside.
Well, that right hand caught him flush on the cheek.
USA!
Come on out here with me, Bubba says. Let's get it on.
Yeah, Duggan was chanting USA. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we got a fight on the floor. Uh-oh. Somebody's going to get a ring post. It's Bubba. And that is very, very hard, as you know. Right hand.
Man.
Down he goes.
What a prime matchup of the week we got going right here. Hold prime. Duggan got to beat that count. Got back in there. No, did he? I'm telling you, no, this thing can't be over.
Let's see what happens. The bell sounded.
In the referee's official decision, neither man made it back to the ring by the referee's 10 count. It is ruled a double count out.
So neither man wins the match. Duggan thought he got back in time.
Well, I'll tell you how they feel about it. Look, man, that's like kissing your sister right there. I mean, this thing is over. Bubba and them are just getting into it right here. Referee right on top though.
Every time this happens, try to tear me down while I'm building some other punk up. He ain't having no more.
Oh, Bubba, very angry.
Yes, it is.
And he wants to get back in the ring. Duggan's going to get the old 2x4. And instead of a prime replay, we may have a prime bullet up against the head. We'll be back on Prime. We certainly hope you're having a great 4th of July week, and join us back next week here on Prime as we head towards the big celebration on July 16th at Bash of the Beach. Hogan and Vader will be in that gigantic cage. That's only one of the great matches. Next week, Harlem Heat will be here. The Nasty Boys will be here. A lot will be going on Prime.
Well, we are primed up right in the middle of the heat of the summer, heading towards Bash at the Beach. Getting ready to get out of Prime. Getting ready for a big week next week. Hey, the Apple Sisters is here. See them, Coy. You know what I mean? We got to go over and see them when this.
We got to go. See ya.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
WCW Prime is on the air along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is Tony Schiavone. We have Diamond Dallas in our Prime match of the week. And we have Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater here this week against the Nasty Boys as we head to Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach, coming your way on pay-per-view, Dream.
Tony, everybody talking about California. Getting ready, I got my suntan all on my lotion. But you talk about mooing. Today, the mooing is going to be so heavy on the Prime match of the week because Diamond Dallas is coming out, and I think the dog's going to be there. And when the dog come out, I talk to all them cows out there, and they moo for her.
I bet they do. Fans also on the program this week, Johnny B. Badd, comments from Hulk Hogan as he prepares for the cage encounter against Vader at Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach, and more great information and great action on WCW Prime. Time to go to the ring. Tag team action leading off the program.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Sister Sherry from 110th Street in Harlem, New York, Booker T,
The World Tag Team Champions and Sister Sherry making their way to the ring in this opening bout here on Prime. Oh, look at the glitter there, Dream.
She looks like she's dragging just a little bit right here on the Prime. I'm telling you, looks like she's just meaner than a junkyard dog. Got a face that will stop a clock.
Now, of course, these two men are in the triangle match. As we know, coming up at the Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach this coming week. Just about a week away. Right now, though, in this opening tag team bout as the champs are here, let's go back to ring announcer Dave Penzer.
Your opponents from New York City, Chris Canyon. His tag team partner from Malibu Beach, California, Kip A.B.
All right, Canyon and A.B., the opponents for the World Tag Team Champions. It's so much animosity, Dream, so much on the line when you talk about the triangle match, the Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach coming up. Three teams all going at it at once. And who knows who's going to come out ahead as the World Tag Team Champs.
Well, boy, it goes back a longer than that. You know, when the Harlem Heat come out, Blue Bloods come out, they all came out, Nasty Boys come out. I was wanting Nasty Boys to sneak up from behind and grab them in the hair, grab them by the ears and stuff. Then the Blue Bloods sneaked up behind the Nasty Boys, put them all together in a triangle match. Slim Jim Bash at the Beach. Going to be a good one.
All right. The opening tag team bout. You say a lot of words at one time.
I took that Beverly Woods reading deal, you know.
Yeah, that reading deal?
Yeah.
Evelyn's reading deal.
Evelyn was a girl me and you were. No, anyway. Look at Harlem Heat now.
That was Beverly.
Yeah,
between the shoulder blades now.
Light off of those satin sheets. Anyway, whoa.
They are so powerful. Look at the power of Booker T. Picked him up and then executed a backbreaker nicely. Have a lot of confidence. Some people would call him cocky.
Well, I'll tell you what, I know where they get it from. Sister Sherry took this team because they had the ability to put her mind, deviant as it is, into it. She knows the world of WCW wrestling. And these guys here are on top of the ball game. Nasty Boys, Mean and Andre, Blue Bloods. I really don't know how they go fair in this big fistfight thing we call this triangle match, Slim Jim Bash at the Beach.
You know, that's a good point because they are tremendous wrestlers, are the Blue Bloods. But you got two other teams in there, the Harlem Heat and the Nasty Boys, who are brawlers.
I just said that.
Well, I was explaining to the other people.
That's right.
A roll out of the way, and Amy makes a tag. And look, already in the ring now is Chris Canyon. And he's, wait a minute, the Blue Bloods have arrived.
There they are. Look at this. Ooh, fireworks maybe early. Let's do it. I tell you what.
Would you call this scouting, Dream?
I don't know if this is scouting or what it's doing, but I know that, you know, the Harlem Heat, they did that to the Blue Bloods last week.
Yeah, they did.
You know what I'm talking about?
On the noggin, look at that, repeated blows from Canyon. I'm not so sure how much effect it had.
None. Zero. Neo.
A cheap shot like this.
There you go. Foot to the face.
Cheap shot. That one had some effect. I tell you what, it could be scattered.
Wait. You'd never find the Blue Bloods cheating in any way. This is typical American behavior. I'm dignified. I'm civilized. Wow. Downright disgusting.
Someone shut him up.
I tell you what, the Harlem Heat, they're not in favor with the fans either. Blue Bloods not in favor. Nasty Boy. Oh, look. Yes, let's do it. Somebody bring me my robe.
We might have a triangle match right here.
Oh, this place is going crazy. Nasty Boys on the scene. Blue Bloods on the scene.
Oh, they're in there with the fans. Look at them.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Look at them. Oh, man, and Harlem Heat doing damage in the ring. Kenyon. Kenyon's down.
Now, good point. Meanwhile, it's nothing but business for Harlem Heat. Now, remember, fans, they are the World Tag Team Champions. So coming up at the Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach, the other teams have to beat them.
Well, I tell you what, you talking about electricity. Slim Jim Bash at the Beach getting ready. We're right on it, but right here in this building on Prime, we're seeing it right here. All of them out there. Six of them. Six bad ones.
That is a big power slam, and back to the attack again is Stevie Ray and Booker T. Of course, Sherry remaining it out outside, not really going over where the Blue Bloods were, although they were staring her down. I wonder how much of a factor she's going to be in that triangle match.
Well, let me tell you something. In the wrestling world in WCW, bottom line is Sherry, like I said earlier, she is a super big factor in these guys being world tag team champions. She will do anything in her power at any time, any place, any time of the day, anywhere for these guys to remain that. And I'm going to tell you what, factor, you need to just say, well, that's three teams and Sherry. Let's just put her in the mix, too.
A butt top Harlem hangover from Booker T. Oh, that's awesome. He covers Canyon, that should be it. And it is, it's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners.
I tell you, they want to fight right now. And you know, Dream, if they execute the Harlem hangover, they will win the match. You don't get up from that move.
No, that's a great athletic move. It's tremendous. We've seen it right here.
Oh, shut up. Taking it all out on anybody. Nasty boys.
She forgot the Blue Blood, so she just screamed. Okay.
Oh, I tell you what, wow. What a shot this was right here. Harlem Heat looking good on top of the game. Proving a point out here. The Nasty Boys and Blue Bloods looked on. Here you go now. Got him up. Getting him ready for this. There it is, whoa, man. That's a great move right there. Harlem Heat to the pay winner. Nasty Boys. Blue Bloods, look out for Harlem Heat and Sister Sherry.
They are the World Tag Team Champs. Coming up next, Johnny B. Badd on Prime. Back on WCW Prime, along with former heavyweight champion of the world, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is Tony Schiavone as we head towards Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach. Coming up on pay-per-view on July 16th.
Well, I tell you what, Johnny B. Badd brings so much excitement to this arena. Slim Jim Bash of the Beach, you see Schiavone, the man himself, the magazine Dusty Rhodes, right here on Prime. Big Prime cuts going on today. Big main events. We hot right here. Johnny B. Badd got it. Ghetto blaster, if you will. Is that it? Is that what he called that?
That's good enough.
That's great.
Watch out.
Ah, a frisbee thing, Johnny. Throw it over here.
Back.
Oh,
well,
foul ball.
He threw it all the way back where he, from whence he came.
Well, maybe he only got one.
Now, here he goes again. Watch out,
what
cameraman.
Oh, man, right up here on our box.
That almost hit you.
Okay, we need that ball net, you know, the baseball net.
Johnny B. Badd had on the end of the blaster there, let's have fun. And that's the good motto. Always have fun, Dream. Whatever you're doing, have fun.
Well, you have to. You know, being competitive is what it's all about. WCW. I mean, since I retired being a broadcast journalist here with Tony Schiavone here on Prime, I see these guys, and they are going at it so hard. And so I'm outside here looking at it in, and I know how hard it is inside there because I've been there, like you said, three-time World Heavyweight Champion. This Slim Jim Bash of the Beach, a lot of things going to transpire right here. Johnny Badd, let's see if he got his work cut out for him.
He has backed him into a corner as Butch Long is his opponent.
Who is it?
Butch Long. No, Long.
Long.
Okay, Long is good enough for
Let's see how long Butch lasts in there with Johnny Badd.
That's a good point. I tell you, he got a knee in.
Yeah, got a fifth too.
Side of the head. Johnny B. Badd in trouble in the early moments of this match. And Butch Long has him caught in the corner, and that's exactly where he wants to.
I'll tell you what. Yeah, he got him. He got his equilibrium off and everything. Got him out of his game plan. He started wailing on his noggin. Another one in the gut.
Johnny B. Badd stood upright that time with a European uppercut. Still has a lot of reserve left, though. Look at this. Fireman's carry. Pick up.
Oh.
Into a crucifix, and what a move it was from Badd.
Well, that was a good move, you know, Johnny B. Badd. He knows all them moves. He's quick. He's got lightning in both hands. Now he's taking it to Mr. Long. Oh, man. He nearly kicked a hole in his belly, Willie.
Hooks him and picks him up and into a powerbomb type maneuver. Johnny B. Badd. How can you be bad when you're so good in the ring like Johnny B.? And he is multi-talented. Here's another fireman's carry pickup. Uh-oh.
Yeah, he set him up on top now. You know, Mr. Long here. What am I doing here? Whoa, look at this. Tone. Will it be?
The Badd Day.
Yes, sir.
Spectacular move by Johnny B. Badd. And covers Long and gets the win. All right. Johnny B. Badd is awesome.
Dream?
Well, that was a good one. Johnny B. Bad looked real good, took shot work. Long didn't last long in there with Johnny B. Bad. I'm going to tell you what, we're going to take another look at it. You talk about a bad day. Johnny Bad picks him up, gets his man all set and ready, drives him down to the mat, and then takes him up 5 million pounds up the air. Bad day time, Johnny B. Bad. Good victory for the man that loves to have fun.
We still have to come in this program. Comments from Hulk Hogan concerning Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach. And much more when Prime continues. But right now, listen to this.
Well, fans, very seldom I have an opportunity to talk about a freebie, but fans from throughout Southern California, this is it, the big weekend, the Bash at the Beach, and this Sunday afternoon at 3 o'clock local time, we're going to be down in Huntington Beach. World Championship Wrestling presents the Bash at the Beach, and it is absolutely free. I understand 40, 50,000 people are going to be there, and some of the action they're going to see, including that big main event with Vader and Hulk Hogan inside a steel cage, will pit this man, Diamond Dallas Page, along with his personal trainer, his co-trainer, I'd have to say, Max Muscle, that's it?
Absolutely.
Yes, and the Diamond Doll. But anyway, Mr. Page is going to be doing battle with a man that kind of embarrassed him recently. I'm talking about Dave Sullivan.
I'm telling you again, get off the embarrassment. It never happened in your arm wrestling. It was an optical illusion. I was just simply distracted for a moment.
Oh, I've got bad eyes, right? That's
what you're saying? Obviously. Hey, down at the beach in Huntington Beach, can you imagine all the Diamond Dolls trying to get over to Diamond Dolls Page? Wannabe Diamond Dolls, of course. What are you pointing him for?
Is he going to be wearing a tin or a tutu?
What are you talking to him like that for? Are you out of your mind? Is he out of his mind, Max?
Absolutely.
You idiot. Get it over here. Well, you know, I heard it's a freebie down there. Most people ain't got the cash that Diamond Dolls Page has got. I mean, I got money I haven't folded yet. But for all those freebie wanters, all those Copenhagen dipping, coupon clipping, draft beer drinking rednecks in Huntington, you get to see Diamond Dallas Page live and in color because he is rolling. And I'm going to roll right over the bunny boy, Dave Sullivan, at the Beach Blast. When is that?
That's going to be this Sunday at 3
Sunday,
o'clock local 3 time.
3 o'clock. Check it out. Be all that you can be. See some real men down at the beach. Max Muscle and Diamond Dallas Page.
Now, this guy will pick up a tab real quick. He throws quarters around like they're manhole covers. 3 o'clock this Sunday. In Huntington Beach, Bash at the Beach. Be part of it.
We are back on Prime, and Dream, we are heading towards Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach. One of the matches will be a return match, and what a great match. Oh, watch out. Better get that camera out of the way. Those cameras cost a lot of money.
I tell you what, I don't think he really worried about what the cameras cost. You know, Colonel Parker got him primed because that was a tremendous match. I know you're going to talk about Sting and Ming at the Great American Bash, but at the Slim Jim Bash at the Beach, Ming and Sting getting back together, Parker had to be brilliant.
What?
To get this thing back together so fast. I'd like to, you know, wow, you're looking awesome.
Return match for the U.S. title. His opponent is Julio Sanchez.
Oh, Julio from Buenos Aires. Yes, sir. Julio Sanchez looking like a leftover from the Grateful Dead concert. Julio came all the way over here on a boat last week, Jack, because I seen him before he went on tonight. He's ready. All the way from Buenos Aires, brother. Look at old Julio. Got that old hat curled up.
He better stay away from the... Oh,
he told me he was lightning.
Yeah, well, lightning has struck in the form of Ming with a head. Look at this. Ming, oh, completely dominating the match here. Oh. Julio may have to go back to, where was that he's from?
Buenos Aires, brother.
Buenos Aires.
Right down there by Macon, right on the other side.
Into the midsection, right hand to the jaw.
You know, we make a lot of Julio, but I'm going to tell you what, it takes something just to get in there with me.
Yeah, it does.
I mean, I talked to him before he went on. He told me all the things. He had a game plan. This ain't it, I don't think. You know what I mean?
The game plan should have been when the bell rings, run. Because that's your only offense would be a defense to stay alive. Ming may be looking at becoming the next U.S. heavyweight champion if he keeps his onslaught up. You know, some people after they drop a match, there's a two count, they start to get on in a slump. But Ming has picked it up a notch since then.
Yeah, he's in no slump. You know, Parker ain't going to let him get in the slump. It was a tremendous match. Sting is the United States heavyweight champion. Big return match going on at the Slim Jim Bash at the Beach.
one thing about Ming is I don't think he really knows what a slump is. I mean, he looks good today. This kid from Buenos Aires, old Julio Sanchez, is just about ragtag to death right here.
Backbreaker.
Stay down, Julio. Stay down.
Well, he got up. Now he's down now, Dream.
Julio's down.
Down for the count. It's over. Ming dominates the match. You're right. Absolutely awesome. One of the more fierce competitors, more feared competitors as well in WCW, Ming.
Well, that was an awesome shot Julio Sanchez took. I know all his fans back there in Buenos Aires. I wonder if he's okay. I don't even see him there. It must be a spot on the ring.
I think that's what he is.
Well, he got nailed, didn't he? Ming looks good. Stinging Ming. Slim Jim. Bash at the beach from California, the burning sand. California. Look at him here, man.
He's still ready to fight. Go ahead, Dream.
Well, right here, you know, you see the replay. You know, Julio Sanchez from Buenos Aires came in with a game plan. Never got to execute it because Ming was on top of him here, slamming him, blaming him, kicking him, storming him, rubbing his nose in the dirt, and then just kicking his brain back the back of his head. Kneeling down on him, Minger, Stinger, Slim Jim, Bash at the Beach.
Coming up next, comments from world champion Hulk Hogan about the Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach. Still to come, Taskmaster, a big tag team match in our prime match of the week.
Hi again, folks. What a weekend. Gene Okerlund back to the WCW Control Center. It all happens this Sunday evening. Bash at the Beach, brought to you by Slim Jim. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim. This Sunday evening, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach. Call your cable company now regarding pay-per-view availability. As I said last weekend, the war at the shore taking place out in Southern California tomorrow afternoon and evening. Inside a 15-foot-high steel cage, WCW heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan defending against the monstrous challenger, 452, Big Van Vader. Vader recently on a tour. I'm going to talk about that in a moment. But standing by right now on the beach, a man I joined this past week, along with Jimmy Hart, WCW heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan. It's got to be a Hulkamaniac, Hulk Hogan, the big kahuna in person. Look at this. As we get ready for the Bash at the Beach this Sunday night, exclusively on pay-per-view, inside the steel cage, you and Vader for the WCW heavyweight title. And what about this guy knocking four down at one time?
Well, you know something, Mean Gene? This little dude right here, he represents the power of all those Hulkamaniacs out there, brother. It was me and my Hulkamaniacs against the whole world, dude. Thanks, big man. Thanks for all the help. You know something, Mean Gene? Now that we're so close to this cage match, I got the eye of the Hulkster back, brother. Everybody's shaking in their boots. Everybody realizes that the Bash of the Beach not only has Hulk Hogan's reputation on the line, the WCW title's on the line, but the whole future Jimmy Hart of the WCW rests on the Hulkamaniac shoulders. Tell him, Hart.
Let me tell you something, baby. Vader, it's not Vader time. It's Hulkster time. And when he steps in that 15-foot steel cage with you, baby, in Southern California, the earth is going to tremble. It's going to shake. And the Hulkster will come out with a WCW Heavyweight Championship belt, baby.
You know, I hate this to be a wake-up call, Hulk Hogan, but Monday morning, this could all be over. I mean, it's conceivable.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be over. It's going to be over for Vader time, brother, because I got the longboard waxed up. I'm going to put his big stinky carcass on it after I run his face into the mesh in the cage. And what you're going to do when the great white in the Pacific runs wild on you?
By the way, Vader recently aligned with the Dungeon of Doom, Hulk Hogan, and Big Van Vader in a cage at Bash at the Beach. Plus, the feud continues between the Nature Boy Ric Flair and the Macho Man Randy Savage. This time, the ring will be surrounded by 12 to 15 lifeguards. In a return for the United States heavyweight title, Sting defends against Ming. In a wild triangle match for the WCW tag team titles, It's Champions Harlem Heat with Sister Sherry, the Nasty Boys, and the Blue Bloods. Three teams in all. New World Television champ, the Renegade, with Jimmy Hart, defends against the winner of the recent Slim Jim Challenge, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. As I mentioned last weekend, a couple of other matches. Hacksaw Jim Duggan to meet Ugandan Giant Kamala with Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan from the Dungeon of Doom. And a straight-up return, it's Diamond Dallas Page against Dave Sullivan. You know what happened after that date that Dave Sullivan had with the Diamond Doll. Bash at the Beach, sponsored by Slim Jim and available on pay-per-view on home satellite. Call Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266. For DirecTV, your telephone number, 1-800-347-3288. See it live this Sunday evening at 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 out of the West Coast. Folks, make the appropriate call. Make it early so you don't miss Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. You are the judge, jury, and executioner. Judge Dredd is coming to all major video game systems June 16th from Acclaim. Take the law into your own hands.
We're getting very, very sleepy, Now step out of it! It's them and old beefy, spicy Slim Jim, oh yeah!
Attention citizens, be on the lookout for Judge Dredd, Mean Machine, and all the Judge Dredd action figures. There's a battle for justice in every action pack. Judge Dredd, packs sold differently.
Kevin Sullivan, at least he used to be called Kevin Sullivan, is now called Taskmaster. And a man who went to the Dungeon of Doom and was transformed into whatever now has picked up an ally by the name of Kamala.
Well, let me tell you something about the Dungeon of Doom. When the Taskmaster went into the Dungeon of Doom, poof, blew him out the other side of the wall. And here come this big giant Ugandan named Kamala. The Taskmaster Kamala, the guy in the Dungeon of Doom, sit on that big chair with cobwebs and stuff rolling down his head. It was awesome. And just go. It was awesome, and just going to be an awesome look.
Kamala will face Hacksaw Jim Duggan at Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach.
Sullivan!
Go to the Dungeon of Doom.
Father, I have drank from the goblet of darkness, and now I feel your power. Father, now I know why we can crush the immortal Hulk Hogan and all those Hulkamaniacs. Father, what gift you give me next? I can't wait.
Taskmaster, my son, the warrior that I bring to you is a of the Sahara Desert, a warrior who has slain the beasts on the slopes of Mount Kilimanjaro from the deepest, darkest part of the African continent. I bring you the Ugandan giant Kamala!
So the Taskmaster adds to his collection of friends or allies, Kamala.
Kamala, Ugandan giant. There he is, look at the Taskmaster. We're called at the feet of Ugandan mountains there, and the big thing, we've seen all the videos and everything. I'm going to tell you what, this Taskmaster can't get any meaner than it was, so I'm anxious to see how he handles this situation.
Ron Thompson, his opponent, Taskmaster, and there's Thompson ready to go. He better be ready. Here he comes, the Taskmaster, taking charge of the match, and Thompson, well, the match is over. The match is over. He threw him over the top rope.
Yeah, but he don't care. You know what
no,
I mean?
You're right about that.
Yeah, the Taskmaster, the rogue just happened to be there. This is what he likes doing right here.
Ron Thompson will win this match by disqualification, but he's going to lose the war here, fans, because the Taskmaster is snapped.
Wow. We need some help out there. I'm going to tell you what. He's going to injure this kid right here. Oh, man, meet them steps.
Hit first on the steps. We need some help to control this maniacal man, the Taskmaster, who loses to Ron Thompson. Oh, my goodness. Head first to the steps again.
Oh. Well, I'll tell you what, he's made them things in right there. Wherever he was, transpired, or whatever happened to him in the weirdness that we had seen, I'll tell you what, he has gotten meaner than I thought he could be.
When we come back, our main event, Nasty Boys, Buck and Slater, and the referees need some help.
This is chaos. Total chaos.
Fans, we'll be back on Prime.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
Again, please.
Again?
Again.
Art thou bored?
Yeah.
Step into a Slim Jim. Turn to the spice. That baby juicy taste. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim.
We are back on Prime, and fans, thank you very much for coming back with us. We apologize for what occurred during the previous segment. The Taskmaster finally, thanks to our director of security, Doug Dellinger, finally left the arena. The arena was cleared. Some other men came in. They were nailed as well. Nick Patrick seems to be okay, but he's a nut. I'm talking about Taskmaster, not Doug Dellinger.
Yeah, they both are.
Yes.
But I tell you what, if we think it's going to settle down here on Prime now, you got another thing coming right here. You got Dick Slater and Buckhouse Buck against the Nasty Boys. Anything could happen. We already seen a situation with the Blue Blood, the Nasty Boys, Harlem Heat, all, you know, well, that's what I'm talking about. Out of the mouth of babes.
Here they come. Regal, Eaton, the Blue Bloods, wanting to be the next World Tag Team Champs, looking at the former champs, the Nasty Boys. You're talking about three teams who don't like each other at all.
Well, I think this one might explode right here. You really got four teams when you talk about Harlem Heat, Buckhouse Buck, Slater, Nasty Boys, Blue Bloods. Ain't nobody like anybody here.
Could be a quad match instead of a triangle match.
Yeah, it could be a quandary. They could get themselves into a quandary.
A quandary?
Yeah, the big hole they dig dirt out and everything. A quandary. And they all get down in there and get after it. The roadism.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
And the fans who've been watching Prime.
Yes, they all
know. They all know.
Yeah.
All right. Neutral position. They go back to a neutral corner. And this is where Sags does not want to be. He wants to keep his back towards his partner and not towards Bunkhouse. But Slater. Nope. Sags holds his ground. Foot to the gut. Great execution. You know, they may brawl and they may have reckless abandon, but they know where to hit you, don't they?
Well,
they know the hurting spots.
Yeah, they know the hurting spots. You know, Slater has got a left-right hand. He's got thunder in both hands, too. Nasty Boys, really, this surprising here, the game plan they got with Slater and Bunkhouse Buck, they slowed this thing down. There's a good tag there. There ain't been no clubbing yet. I'm sure there's going to be some clubbing, but both these teams are capable of clubbing.
The double whip into the far side ropes. Runs right through the dirt man, Dick Slater. Down he goes, and the elbow drop from Brian Knobbs.
The dirt man, Dick Slater. Look at this. There's a Donnybrook going on over there, but you can't turn your back when Dick Slater's there. But Dick Slater hooked him up right here. See, that ain't clubbing. That was one hand, see? Clubbing, they got to get together. That'd be all of them at once.
Pulling on the legs. Down low, we got a fight up top.
Oh, man.
A Donnybrook down on the floor, and the fans love it. They're standing everywhere here.
Only on Prime. Only on Prime.
The legal men, I believe, are in the ring, and although I'm not sure that's a clothesline, this one is broken down in a hurry, fans.
Yeah, I tell you what, we said that. Blue Bloods came out. I think they just irritated the Nasty Boys. Got them all irritated. Now they're in there just stomping on. Blue Bloods got that scout report. They went back, but they are in the building. We know they are here. Looky here.
What?
Over here. Right, look right down behind this guy's head we're looking at.
What? A fan?
Sheriff. No, a sheriff.
Sheriff?
I can see him. Look behind. Sit down in front.
Hey, look. Doug Dellinger may have seen if they bought tickets.
Well, you know they didn't buy tickets wearing that garb they got on.
I've seen some wilder things from fans.
I have too, but Doug Dellinger knows better than that. Look at that. Good shot of the back of Doug's head.
Look at that. Yeah, she's going to go nowhere. See that? She put her hand right on that rail and dared him to move.
Well, there ain't nobody. I'll tell you what, I still say she's the toughest woman in the business. I mean, any business. I don't even monkey business.
I believe so. Fans, the tape machines are rolled into the match.
No, man.
And during the break, we'll show you what happened on instant replay. But Dream, we got to take a break here on WCW Prime.
Why is that always happening?
All right, we are back on Prime, and the Donnybrook, and that's a mild term compared to what we're seeing, continues here. An elbow from Dick Slater. I tell you, now we're talking a lot about the three teams in the triangle match. Like you said, Dream, don't count out Slater and Buckhouse Buck when it comes to vying for the World Tag Team title. They're looking pretty darn good here.
Well, you know, they had some involvement on the last pay-per-view.
Yes, they did.
You know, you talk about the Great American Bash that led into this Slim Jim Bash at the Beach. I mean, a lot of things went down. Buckhouse Buck and Dick Slater, they weren't just as bad as anybody out there of them teams to be World Tag Team champion. They have that ability, too. They have a thing that they have going for them, too, in Colonel Parker, just like Harlem Heat has Sheriff. You know what I mean? They got Colonel Parker, great, great mind that he is. That
one,
he said he is.
Two, got a two count, and a great romancer as well, apparently. I mean, he just it looked like something out of Gone with the Wind, you know? Just kind of.
Well, he really had to be either intoxicated, which I know it wasn't, but something was wrong with him to even attempt to kiss that woman on the face.
Well, over the top, should have been a disqualification. But
we've seen that in the last match. The referee back was turned here.
Maybe Colonel Parker really likes Sherry. You know, I mean, to each his own, so to speak.
Wow, he's whipping him now. Whipping him like a dog.
And Sags, not in good shape here, and Buck will come in. Boy, when you get on the outside, and you got Parker out there, and you got Dirty Dick Slater and Bunkhouse Buck, you're in a whole heap of trouble.
Well, this thing is taking a turn for Bunkhouse Buck and Dick Slater because they took the advantage of meanness, if you will, by going outside. And what happens now is the Nasty Boys need to make a tag. They need to get over and make a tag because Slater and Bunkhouse Buck could be taking a little thunder away from the Nasty Boys.
The big tag. And finally, Knobs is in. We know they can fight. We're going to find out how much they have endurance-wise. Ryan Knobs follows up a clothesline with an elbow.
Well, he's taking it right to him. Here comes Slater in there now. You know, Knobs need to really fire on him.
Buck and Sags paired off on the right. I believe the legal man are Brian Knobs and Buckhouse Buck.
Well, your guess is as good as mine because they're all four in there right now. But I believe you're right. We could go for it right here. Get him set up for the blivet. That's Cutter Buck up on the apron.
And a power slam. And Slater and Buck got out of that one.
Uh-oh.
Buck has a belt.
Yes, his belt. In his hand.
In his hand. Around his sisters.
Yeah, and he's going to do carnage, if you will, to the Nasty Boys.
There he goes. To the midsection.
Wow. Oh, he just nailed him.
On the outside. Got him in the head. Staggered him. They got the belt. And they got Buck.
And they got a rib.
And they go through it.
Wow. What a turn of events.
Nasty Boys, the former World Tag Team Champions,
it's running wild.
Get the win. Coming up next, our Prime Match of the Week. Here on Prime, it's Diamond Dallas Page.
Well, you fans here in Southern California, perhaps not. I don't know if they recognize Ralph, but certainly they recognize the visage of the very famous man that is holding Ralph the Rabbit. I'm talking about Dave Sullivan. I call you Evad. I kind of go along with your program.
You're right. You're right what you say, too. You know, yeah, I just get mixed up once in a while.
Sometimes you get things a little,
out of circle?
Out of whack. Coming up on Sunday, July the 16th, in Huntington Beach, fans are going to be coming from all over Southern California. As a matter of fact, they're going to be coming from all over the world. It's going to be free for everybody. They won't have to take a dime out of their pocket for the Bash at the Beach, a big extravaganza presented by World Championship Wrestling. And, Dave, you're going to be a very important part of that event. You're going to be facing Diamond Dallas Page, and this is going to be strictly wrestling. No arm wrestling on this one.
That's good. I just soon get him in that circle squared and wrestle him, you know what I mean, because for what he did to me, you know, on that date, him and that, they double-teamed him and that Max Muscle.
Hey, speaking of date, Dave, you had a date with the Diamond Doll. I feel a little like Chuck Worley here, but how was she? Or how was it?
She's a very nice lady.
She's a very nice lady? She had a good time? You went to a movie?
Yes.
The only thing you got funneled at the end of it, that's...
Yes, that rotten guy and his friend jumped me.
Max. Yeah. Max Muscle. Well, that's
partner.
Too bad.
Yeah.
You know, Diamond Dallas, $13 million, considers himself a pretty bright guy. And at arm wrestling, you put Ralph the Rabbit on the line. He put the Diamond Doll on the line. I don't know just exactly who got the better end of that deal.
Well, you know how it's just like apples and oranges. You never know, you know. Or peas and carrots.
Who writes your material?
Well, just something that comes right up here. Oh, Ralph talks to me about it, too.
I believe Ralph might do that. Thank you very much. Dave Sullivan here in Huntington Beach on Sunday, July the 16th, to meet Diamond Dallas Page. It's the Bash at the Beach.
We're just about set to go, fans, with the prime match of the week. Want to remind you one more time that Bash of the Beach, sponsored by Slim Jims. Of course, it's Slim Jims Bash of the Beach. It's coming your way exclusively on pay-per-view on the... You ready?
I'm ready.
I'm just kind of filling for time for you to get warmed up here. On the 16th of July, it comes your way from Southern California, Huntington Beach. And, of course, we'll start at 3 o'clock in the afternoon down in Huntington Beach, and we'll take the air on pay-per-view at 7 o'clock Eastern time. Go get them.
What they... Get them back from here. All them cows trying to get in here. The only one I have chosen to move today for DDP and the Diamond Doll. This is going to be exceptional. Here it is. Time cut. Match of the week. Ready, boys.
Ready, boys.
Up there. Get them. Get back.
It is time for the prime match of the week. World Championship Wrestling presents the top stars, because this is where the big boys are. Yow is right. The Diamond Dogs leads in DDP and Max Muscle and Wildcat Willie. Well, there goes Willie.
What happened to Willie? He broke down, brother.
He did.
She broke Willie right down, man. He never been around anything so pretty. You know, I tell everybody all over the world, especially all the little girls that watch Prime out there, you got to drink your milk, eat your carrots, because this is what you're going to look like if you drink your milk, just like the Diamond Doll right here. Beautiful as she is, running around with this old ugly Dallas Page. Bottom line is, he's really come a long, long way. And here's a good test for him. Scotty Armstrong,
the Georgia native and a great, fierce competitor against a arrogant, cocky Diamond Dallas.
Wealthy now. Money to burn.
I guess those are real Oakleys he has on right there instead of counterfeit. Our bogus sunglasses. And here we
bogus.
Go.
Bogus.
Bogus. All right. Max Muscle's down at ringside. And there you see Scott Armstrong casting a weary eye towards the strongman, Max Muscle. All right. Diamond Dallas. What a streak he's on. I mean, we're talking about winning the money, having the beautiful woman by his side with his thug, Max Muscle, and the wins have been coming. Right. But now he's got to go up against Dave Sullivan at the Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach.
Well, the bottom line with this situation here is his progress as a professional wrestler at WCW has been on the rise for the last year. And I'm going to tell you what, I've seen this guy work so hard to get where he's at. I don't like him, arrogant as he is. I mean, look at this. Give me a kiss. Give me sugar.
No.
Sugar me.
For crying out loud.
But he has the ability, as we said, to step up with the big boys. Right here on WCW Prime. This Prime Match of the Week.
Diamond Dallas absorbing the blows of Armstrong. Armstrong will take the fight right to you. We know that about Scott Armstrong. A reverse underhook into a full arm dragon twist. And now pounding away on the shoulder. Look at this.
Yeah, he's ragging on him, and you're right, the Armstrongs, they take the fight to anybody, that whole family. I'm going to tell you what, whoa, man, that's got to hurt your arm. Max Muscle on the outside, the Diamond Dar, but Dave Sullivan, Dallas Page, Diamond Dallas, if you will, Mr. Moneybag, Slim Jim, Bash at the Beach, coming to a head.
Okay, the whip to the near side. Scott Armstrong with a great drop kick. Wouldn't bring him down. That one brings him down and out and through at the feet of the Diamond Dog.
Watch out. Look on top here.
Max Muscle better turn around as well.
Oh, man. Did you see the strength?
Incredible strength from Max Muscle, and that's what I'm talking about. He runs in a gang. Does he, DDP.
He what?
Runs in a gang.
He runs in a gang.
Yes. He has his
You
thug.
Call that a gang, that Max Muscle and the Diamond Dog. Is that a gang?
That's a gang.
No, a gang is 50 guys kicking on your booty out behind the barn. That's a gang. This here is a covey. A covey. Like quail. Three in a covey.
This is a committee.
This is a committee. There ain't no gang.
That's a diamond cutter, though.
That's
one.
The end.
Three. You're not kidding.
I can tell you ain't in no game, fight. One guy and a woman beating you up, that ain't no game. That's a good win. Tell him he's a zero.
That's what he says. Shouldn't tell him that. Because if you beat a zero, who have you beaten?
That's right.
You've beaten nobody.
Nobody. I heard that.
Okay.
I heard that.
You shouldn't do that. It's time for the prime replay, and we go to the American Dream. Dusty Rhodes.
Well, right here on the prime replay, you see high above. Oh, great catch by the center fielder. Max Muscle right there. Oh, man, Dallas drives him in the back. And as Tony said, the game fighting his own. The diamond cutter, hook the leg, Diamond Dallas Page. The prime replay of the week is over.
And we're coming back with a final word on prime. Fans, want to remind you that the Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach comes your way on the 16th of July. That is coming up this coming week. Don't forget to call your local cable operator and join. I want to talk to you about Vader and Hogan in just a moment. Next week here on Prime, the Nasty Boys, the Blue Bloods, Harlem Heat, the Taskmaster will be with us, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. The Taskmaster will be in our Prime match of the week. Hogan and Vader in the cage, one of the most anticipated matches we've ever had at Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach.
You know, a lot of people are writing Hulk Hogan off. They see this time and his career is over for him. This is the one that's going to set the tone for the rest of his life. What are he going to do after? That's not true. His backyard, home field advantage, Hulkamania is running rapid on the beach in California. Beta big, strong, ugly, and bad, but he is not the man they call Hulk Hogan. I'm picking Hogan in this one.
Okay, a pick of Hulk Hogan by the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Come back with us next week for fun and WCW action with the American Dream. I'm Tony Schiavone. See you next week on WCW Prime. WCW Prime is on the air, along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is Tony Schiavone, and Dream, have you seen the program this week?
No, I know that it's going to be hot, because Prime is always hot. And the Prime cut with Tony Schiavone, my main man, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Where's the cat? Take a look at it.
I have it in my hand right here. Okay. Take a look at the program.
Which one?
Right, segment number 4.
Whoa! Whoa, that's hot!
It's the Dungeon of Doom.
Yes.
The Dungeon of Doom.
Which one? Wow, look at that! Look at that! Oh, that's hot!
Absolutely. It's Renegade going up against Buckhouse Buck.
Get him out of here. Let me read the rest of them. Go ahead.
Go ahead. You want to read the rest of them?
No,
what about the prime match of the week? Take a look at that.
Wow!
The prime match of the week. I tell
that's
you,
hot.
We are red hot, as you know, and we are red hot heading to the Clash of the Champions event featuring Vader against two men. Big Van Vader will face the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and Arn Anderson.
That's going to be Tony and Dusty. Stand up.
Oh, my goodness.
Let's go to break. Let's go to match.
Let's go to Sting, the first match in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first from Venice Beach, California, weighing 251 pounds, the United States heavyweight champion, this is Sting!
And you know, Dream, I knew we were excited about something because Sting starts it off here on Prime.
Well, what a start it is to Prime to see the Stinger himself.
They love him everywhere around the world. Let's go back to Dave Pinzer.
His opponent from LaGrange, Georgia, weighing 234 and 1/4 pounds, Golden Boy, Chick Donovan.
Dick Donovan gained a quarter pound since the last time we saw him.
Did what?
You heard Dave Pender.
What he said?
Something in a quarter pound. Eddie was right at an even 239 last time.
Well, he probably put on a little weight for this heavyweight matchup with the man they call Sting. United States heavyweight champion. Truly one of the greats in WCW history.
The Stinger survived the match against Ming recently at Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach, and that's what it was, a survival.
Listen at him here. Electricity running through the veins of Sting. These people screaming and hollering. Chick Donovan, I don't know what kind of game plan he's got with that extra added poundage, but it better be a good one.
It's got to be a good one against Sting. One of the most exciting superstars in our sport. And Nick Patrick in the opening bout here on Prime. Good to have you with us. The fans love Sting, the United States heavyweight champion, a very tentative Chick Donovan, and he ducks low. Huh?
Yeah, if he thinks for 1 second that he's going to psych Sting out, that's what that extra quarter of a pound is. And that bandage you got tied around his arm.
Neutral position for both athletes now. Back they go, and now Sting finds himself pinned in the corner.
Well, let's see if we get a clean break from Chick Donovan. Yep, sure did.
All right. The Stinger. Kind of shocked by that. And there's the full arm dragon twist by Donovan.
Well, I tell you what, he ain't going to rip that arm off. There ain't going to be no code redding going on here. He's got Sting in a good position. He'll got that... little old wrist there, back up there. A lot of pain and pressure. Don't try that at home. Well, here he goes.
Sting now with a full arm dragon twist, and it's also called a reverse forearm abduction, by the way.
Abduction is like something that happened at the Bash at the Beach with me and you the other night, but we can't talk about that.
Well, yes, we had a good time in Huntington Beach.
We were abducted.
The Stinger.
I hope being quiet don't get a hold of that either. Oh, nice move right here, though. Chick Donovan showing a little skill.
And Sting showing a little skill also. Back to go to the corner.
There we go.
Into the midsection.
Well, I knew he was going to open it up. You know what I mean? Toy it with him a little bit, if you will.
Here he comes. He's coming right at you with a Stinger splash.
Oh, yeah. He's going to hook him up now, brother. Look at this, Tony.
Knocking the wind out of him with a Stinger splash. Enabling the Scorpion Deathlock to easily be applied. And this one is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the United States Heavyweight Champion, Sting.
In our dream, that Scorpion Deathlock is awesome, but that Stinger splash stuns him because it's such an awesome move as he propels himself from one corner to the other.
That's so true, so much power when he comes across there. Neil, he got your kind of wobbly leg. Don't know where you're at. We're going to take a look at it anyway, right here. Here it comes, full force, brother. Drives into him, boom. Well, right here, Chick Donovan, don't know where he's at. Staggers out, and the Stinger hooks that Scorpion and turns him over. Not only does it go to the pay window, but the United States Heavyweight Champion is looking good on the prime.
A fan, you heard the Dream say there's no code red in here. There's going to be code red in coming up because... The Sarge, the Pitbull Craig Pittman, coming up next as we continue on WCW Prime. Welcome back to WCW Prime, along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Tony Schiavone here, and everyone stand at attention, please. The Pitbull is here. Oh, he's got his... belt on. What's that, the ammunition belt, Green?
Well, it's either that or one of them...
What do I see? What? But civilians want to be like me.
Yeah, well, it's either that or one of them big Mr. T chains, you know. But look at the eyes here, though. You talk about intensity. Mr. Pittman's got intensity. But, you know, I still go on record. I'm going to say it again, that we talk about his amateur background. We talk about his cauliflower ears. Talk about his code red. Talk about his intensity. But for me to see a kid transpire or a man transpire into a great WCW great athlete, he has to step up. And that means against the likes of the Stinger, against the Hogans, against the Renegades, against the Iron Anderson. He's got to step up to the plate against somebody besides this guy, Mr. Dreyer, is in dire straits out here with him.
Yeah, he wouldn't want to transpire with Dyer out there. from the neutral position now. Dyer went to wrestling. Nice go behind, but that was about it. And Pittman using the momentum to take him over. Pittman is so strong, so powerful, not only the upper body, but the legs as well.
He's also, in most cases, they showed he's one-dimensional. What I mean by that is that he'll take that arm and just concentrate it. So I think a great game plan would be go out there, keep him from getting that arm, which is hard to do. I understand that situation. But do something other to him to let him get in a position where he's got to do something else. Look at that. Doing push-ups right here on his opponent. I've seen this somewhere before. It might have been the other night, but...
Where was that?
No, I'm talking about wrestling.
Well, I know you are. The looks like a form of an arm bar, or was that a wrist lock? We really can't tell from this vantage point.
Well, it's the arm. That's the bottom line. Trying to get it ready for the code red. I know that for a fact. Oh, yeah. Just nailed him right there. Staying on that arm. That's his forte, if you will. Right there, that arm. Dragging and ragtagging. I believe he could fall back and code red him right here, Tony.
Now he can do more than code red him. He can snap it right off. Pull it right out of the shoulder. An undisciplined civilian is what he's saying there, Dream.
Yeah, look at this. I think he has got this situation well in hand.
The pit bull, Sergeant Craig Pittman, the former Marine sergeant who's made the smooth, and I emphasize that, smooth transition into WCW. That's not an easy thing to do.
No, it's not, and a lot of people are finding out. Dyer Straits right here is finding out himself when he checked in on this match. Whoa, look at him blow through the belly welly.
Wow. Not only an accomplished wrestler, but looks like he spent a lot of time on the punching bag as well.
Come on, son.
Pittman pulling down the arm again. He loves submission holds.
You want to go home, mama? Don't you, son? You want to go home, mama?
Oh, man, look at that. That's insulting right there. Not only trying to break your arm, but slapping you in the face and talking about your mama.
Well, I bet you when he was a drill instructor, he was tough.
Yeah, I bet you when he was a drill instructor, he was tough.
Yeah, I bet you when he was a drill instructor, he was tough.
Yes, sir, brother. You said that.
Yeah, so did you.
Yeah. Well, right here, look at this. Uh-oh. Stepping on his arm now.
And it's a wonder that Dyer doesn't give up right now. But he continues the assault here. You are taking a look, fans, at a wrestling machine. And it's just hard to tell exactly where he'll end up. He could become a champion in short order here in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, as I said earlier, I'd like to see that happen. I mean, I'd like to see the opportunity for him to do that, to step up and do that. Being in the eyes of many of the ring legendary figures that watch WCW Prime, they'd be satisfied. Look at this now. When he's doing the push-up, if I was Dyer, I would go over and kick him right in the face, kick him in the belly, well, then turn him over. And I think, look at that. There's Walkhead Willie even hollering at Dyer, kick him in the stomach.
But Dyer can't even get to his feet. He's up to one knee, his arm's hurting, and Pittman knows he wouldn't do that if the guy wasn't down. Now, would he? Well, you never know.
Yeah, man, look at that forearm across the nostril and the face. Man, that'll mess your complexion up.
Dragging, and Dyer cannot even get to his feet. He just drags him on his knees and pounds away on the arm. Now has the head.
Well, I guarantee you one thing. Pittman would love to break this guy's arm right here, because that's what it's all about with him. Pain, blues, and agony.
Are they chanting USA here?
Well, chanting USA. I tell you, maybe some of the fans like Pittman and what he stands for, but he's the mean one, I'm telling you. It doesn't mean, it doesn't mean that you're bad if you're intense. Whoa, look at that shot.
A whole lot of carbon dioxide came right out of those lungs on that one.
That is code red.
For the car, says the Sarge. Wow. That was quite a clinic in how to destroy a young man. And that's what he did. Destroyed him.
Boy, you looking in my eyeballs there, I'm telling you. That tells it all right there. How I always used to look at a man's eyes to see how intense he was.
Begins right here.
Well, the Marine Corps probably proud of it.
Well, we're going to take another look right here. I'll tell you what, a little belly to belly there kind of softened him up, but he had really ragtagged that arm this whole match. Used his head as a human battering ram. And then hooks that arm in there. Cold reds it right here. Craig Pitbull Pittman takes another victory to the house.
The Pitbull Craig Pittman, your winner here on WCW's Prime. Still to come, a man who in a few short weeks will face two men, and that's Big Van Vader next on Prime. Well, Dream, I tell you, Vader has made a living off destroying two-minute ones. We have seen him in many handicap matches throughout his career. But this time, it's a little bit different, as Big Van Vader will meet Arn Anderson and the Nature Boy Ric Flair in our Clash of the Champions event. Check your local listings for that. It's coming up on Sunday, August 6th.
Yeah, he is a man on a mission, and I tell you what, Vader is so bad, so quick and agile for the size that he possesses. And whatever made you think for 1 second that Arn Anderson and the Nature Boy Ric Flair gonna both try to handle him at Clash of the Champions?
Forearm shot, gut shots. Vader is just awesome.
Yeah, well, he's moving through this thing just with reckless abandon, if you will. A storm, if you will, on storm.
Now back it out of the corner.
Heavy, heavy forearm. Whoa. Hello.
Great sound when Vader's in the corner there, isn't it? I mean, it hurts to listen to him.
Well, it hurt a lot more being in there with him. I'd rather be listening to him, you know what I mean, in my retired state that I'm in, than being in there with him. I'm telling you, you're right, though. Got great production and sound and camera work going on. They get the full effect of how big this guy is. There he goes, the second rope. Brother, he could squash this guy right now.
Well, that's what he's going to do, I think. Vader on the middle turnbuckle, 425.
Yeah, and it's over.
It's over when he wants it to be, Dream, I guess.
Yeah, he didn't call this one. I'm telling you. Wow.
World
no, man, look here. We'll pick him up. Power Vader bomb.
The Vader power bomb. Ho! That won't hurt. And Vader, the monster he is, covers.
That is it.
That's it. You know, he picked him up there. That's it, though, man. This guy has been so on the verge, Tony, of being, I mean, he's been fine. He's been disrupted at everything. I mean, he has no remorse, if you will, for anybody, including the referee, or Nick Bockwinkel, our official with WCW.
Well, I know what you mean.
Get away from me.
Pushing Nick Patrick down, slapping Storm right in the face. The referee is down. The opponent is down. Someone is going to have to control this man. And I'm not so sure it's going to be Flair and Arn Anderson.
Now, I'll tell you what, boy. They made their statement, and, I mean, he answered it. Whoa, look at this. I mean, man, Nick Buckley has got to be taking a look at this situation right here. Got to be, Tony.
Hogan, this man's on your head. He's yours.
Oh no, man, no! He's gonna powerbomb him right down the floor.
Oh my goodness! Time to get out the gurney here, and Vader.
Yeah, insult to injury, brother. That's what it's called. Big Van Vader, the baddest of them all, without a doubt.
No man, no fear,
no better,
no pain,
no fear, no pain.
No man.
Big Van Vader, there's Randy Anderson out, but he got a sidestep. I don't blame him. Nick, oh, he's reaching for the fans, too.
Wow, look at this shot right here, this big slow-mo brother. He just powers him right there. Way off the top, picks him up in the Van Vader power bomb there, leads him all the rest. Gets the cover for the 1-2-3, and then power bombs him on the floor at an insult to injury.
He insulted the man, and he certainly did injure him as well. Coming up next, the Dungeon of Doom on Prime.
A group of men known as the Dungeon of Doom out to destroy Hulkamania. We have seen Kamala, of course, the first man was Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan. We have seen Shark. We have seen the newest man, Zodiac. And now there's talk about yet another man entering the Dungeon of Doom.
You know, Tony, we had so much good time on the Prime. but fierceness takes over sometime. Kevin Sullivan in the Dungeon of Doom is drawing up from the deepest, darkest depths and bringing out monsters, if you will, to get rid of Hulk Hogan.
It's not easy to get rid of Hulk Hogan. Just ask the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Just ask Vader. Ask many men. But there's no question about it. The purpose of the Dungeon of Doom has been to destroy Hulkamania. Even notice that Kevin Sullivan, the Taskmaster, has Hogan's colors, red and yellow.
Yeah, he got his colors, and he thinks that he got him nailed. But I don't think so for Hulkamania.
We're going to take a look right now at all the members of the Dungeon of Doom and a promise of a new warrior to come. Take a look.
Father, I know it's instant stone, but tell me, who is the great warrior that will come out of it? Is it Kamala?
Taskmaster! Kamala is a great warrior, but I have other plans for Kamala. Back in the darkness! Kamala!
Back in the darkness!
Father, will it be the Zodiac that will be my warrior?
Yes! No! He is too valuable of a warrior!
No!
Because, Taskmaster, this is the brother of goodness himself! Go back into the land of yin yang!
Yes! No! Yes! No!
No!
Yes!
Yes!
Father, I think I know the answer! Hulk Hogan is only a man, and you're gonna send a man-eater! Shock attack!
The shark is already surfing the largest tsunami of all. He is on a tidal wave, chasing the millions and millions of the maniacs, biting and chewing his way to the immortal Hulk Hogan. Keep surfing! Keep surfing! The tidal wave, son!
Be patient, my son! Be patient! He will be coming!
I have no idea who this new warrior is, but the master says he is coming, and apparently it is the man they think will destroy Hulkamania.
Well, you know, they talk about that. They've seen the Zodiac. Yes, no, maybe. We've seen monsters. We've seen sharks. Van Vader himself and a new man talking about destroying Hulkamania. I don't think so, baby.
We'll just have to wait and see. Fans still to come in this telecast, the prime match of the week, and the World TV champ, Renegade, coming up against Bunkhouse Buck. Stay with us. Well, here we are back on WCW Prime. We've just witnessed another Dungeon of Doom. I don't know who this next warrior is that the master says for Taskmaster to be patient. He's coming, but apparently this is the most dangerous man of all. And these guys we're watching right now, the Taskmaster. Look, eyes rolled back and he said, gee, Monique.
You know, Lee ain't the worst part. I'll tell you something else, Tony Schiavone. They got one goal and one mutual thing in common in that Dungeon of Doom, and that is to destroy Hulk Hogan. Each and every one of these men were brought forth in the dungeon to do that task. And speaking of the Taskmaster, I don't know how he's going to be handling Kamala in this situation right here.
The opponents are Chris Canyon, Eddie Jackie. Canyon on your right, Jackie on your left, and here we go. It has to be, regardless of who you are, Hulk Hogan or any opponent like Jackie or Canyon, has to be very intimidating to see guys like Kamala and Kevin Sullivan looking across the ring at you.
Well, you couldn't imagine, I mean, seeing something looking across at you like that. And oh, man, right here, speaking of the taskmaster, taking the task, what he's got to do.
Was he going to face two men here? It's a tag team match.
Well, I tell you, that's what I said. The bottom line with Kamala, he doesn't really communicate that well. And, well, look at this. Look at Kamala there, sitting out there like he's on his front porch. Sitting out there somewhere on his front porch, looking at his headgear. Ain't paying no attention as the taskmaster is roughing up these two guys.
He went to tag Kamala, and there was no Kamala to be found. And I don't think the taskmaster's concerned. Well, he may be concerned now.
Well, he's got to go communicate with him.
Kill Hulkamania!
Whoa.
Hulkamania!
I did it.
Yeah, that got him going.
Yeah, Hulkamania, that seems to be the key word right here. Hulkamania.
Like saying paycheck to my wife.
Exactly.
Jab to the top of the head, yeah. That gets her going. Into the midsection. Headbutt. Down goes Chris Canyon, and I mean it, got him moving. Big chop, and outside goes Eddie Jackie.
Well, Eddie Jackie, I don't think really wants to be in there. Well, caught him right on top of the head. Just enough there to daze him a little bit, and they gave him that big old footsie right in the mouth. Hello, I would like for you to take a look at my headpiece. It's exactly what he told him.
And it looked like stars to Chris Canyon.
Yes, he did. And I think that this guy is so agile and mean, and I really believe, oh yeah, I want you to see it too. Well, they both laid the waste.
The best thing could have happened to Canyon and Jackie was that Kamala stayed on the outside.
Yeah, oh, this match got postponed.
Meanwhile, Jackie is going to be assaulted by Kevin Sullivan, the taskmaster on the outside, and Kamala. Well, he understands no.
Yeah, I believe that. He understands about dishing out some pain. I know that for a fact.
Kamala with a kick.
Yeah, really agile for as big as he is. He really is. When you take a hard cold look at it in pro wrestling, you see a lot of big guys. We just seen an agile guy invader. I mean, brother, this guy just left the ring.
Oh, and Kevin, the taskmaster with a double stomp.
Ripping and tearing and snorting. I'm telling you. Is this Canyon here?
That was poor old Chris Canyon. And Kamala's got him again.
He put that old ham hock up over there, choked him right there and got him out. He's out on his feet right here. He's not on his feet, he's laying down. But Kamala just continued the barrage.
Say what you want to about him. I know the fans, as you can see, they don't like him. They despise him. And they are certainly very effective in the ring. I mean, they dominate a match.
Well, one thing is for certain, the camp of Hulk Hogan, they got to really be watching this thing, man. I know he's got people that watch these things, and I know he is very interested in this thing. And here the crowd start coming with Hogan right here.
The chant of Hulk Hogan is Kamala again on the attack, and a warning from Randy Anderson, the use of the ropes. Nicely shielded that time by Kamala.
Shielded. Get it? He used his shield.
The taskmaster's in the crowd.
Yeah, he had went out to talk to somebody about the situation at hand with Hogan, and now he's coming back. We're fired back here. Not for long.
The taskmaster's in the stands, and he doesn't even have a ticket, for crying out loud. Now he crawls back in. Chop to the chest.
Whoa.
And the big Kamala splash. He can hook a far leg, and he wins. Thank goodness for Jackie and for Canyon. This one is over.
Well, boy, right here, you know, shading his eyes are hiding from the situation, seems to control him. But we've seen him just unleash him when he mentioned Hulkamania.
Never say the word Hulkamania to Kamala. That's the lesson we've learned here.
When you see the big guy right here, he throws this guy in, catches him flush right there. He's already got him just wailing and stomping mud holes in him. Then the big splash, Kamala and the Taskmaster take a win.
Once again, the question remains, who is the new warrior? And hopefully we'll find out in the weeks to come. Coming back, a look at the Clash of the Champions.
Hi again, everybody. I'm Gene Okerlund, reminding you this report is brought to you by Slim Jim. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim. What a totally chaotic afternoon and evening last Sunday out in Southern California. Bash at the Beach may well be history at World Championship Wrestling, but we're going to be feeling reverberations for a long time to come. We're going to get away from that California fault line and head back to the great sunshine state of Florida for Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions. Sunday, August the 6th at 7 o'clock, live in front of a national television audience. Check your local listing for time and station. Now, forget cogent thinking. Egos cannibalized each other last weekend, and as a result, one man, Big Van Vader, challenged two men, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, in a handicap match. This particular match put together during the heat of the battle, these men are not going to have an opportunity, from what I've been told, to rethink their decisions. And also, at Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions, in a huge return match, World Television champ The Renegade defends one more time against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Of course, Jimmy Hart will be in the Renegade's corner. It's in prime time on national TV again. Check your local listing for time and station. It's going to be live from Daytona Beach, Florida, and that's 2 weeks from this Sunday, August the 6th. It's Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions. Fans, a reminder, WCW once again is setting the standard in wrestling. And in keeping with that, we're excited to present Collision in Korea, exclusively on pay-per-view, Friday, August the 4th. Over 300,000 fans on hand as WCW and New Japan brought pro wrestling to North Korea. See the Nature Boy Ric Flair and Tony Onoki and other great international stars in this history-making event. Available Friday, August 4th, only on pay-per-view.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. Your judge, jury, and executioner. Judge Dredd is now available for all major video game systems from Acclaim. Take the law into your own hands.
We're getting very, very sleepy,
Now step out of it! It's Devin old Beefy Spicy Slim Jim, oh yeah!
Attention citizens, be on the lookout for Judge Dredd Mean Machine and all the Judge Dredd action figures. There's a battle for justice in every action pack. Judge Dredd, pack sold differently.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature contest is for the World Television Championship and is set for one fall. Introducing first the challenger, being led to the ring by Colonel Robert Parker from Bucksport, Tennessee, weighing 253 pounds, Bucks Book.
Well, Bucksport, Tennessee. I wonder if they've ever seen anything like the Renegade in downtown Bucksport.
I doubt that seriously, brother. I'm telling you. Renegades don't run around in Bucksnot late at night.
If so, they meet someone like Colonel Parker's Pride Joy Bunkhouse Buck. Very successful in this sport. Back we go to Dave Penzer.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, the World Television Champion, the Renegade!
Hang on now, here he comes! And he's getting in the ring so quickly, he left Jimmy Hart!
Well, he's high energy, brother. Always moving. Oh, man, you just got to be able to control him in a situation now. Bunkhouse Buck has to be able to take away all this movement from this guy, or he'll be discombobulated this whole match right here on the prime.
You don't want to get discombobulated. No question about that.
Got them big old tattoos, arms on his shoulders.
The Renegade and Buck.
You're the man out here. He belongs to you, Buck.
Little pep talk going on there.
Yes, sir. He's trying to get him right. Trying to get him right. As you said, his pride and joy right there. That's one way to get him right. Get him outside and stop this.
Pounding away, Buck and Renegade. Whoa. Renegade picks him up.
Ooh.
Oh. That hurt me. And you know it hurt Buck.
Yeah, that'll make your back crack and your liver quiver right there. Make your knees freeze. Old Buck is on the move, too.
Side headlock.
Well, that's unusual for the Renegade. Side headlock.
It is. Usually just runs right through you.
That's what
away.
I'm talking about, Tom.
Ah.
And he holds on. Uh-oh. Buck moved him into the corner. He snatches a headlock again.
Yeah, but he wasn't in a position now when he moved him in to get loose from that.
Down goes Bunkhouse Buck. Wow, back body drop.
Yeah, took him for the ride right there. Guarantee it. Now Buck is going to go back out to Colonel Parker and try to get his rep attendant straight.
The best rep attendant he can do right now is just to stay right there.
Well, he's about lost his suspenders, his draws, everything else. But he's trying to stop the Renegades onslaught.
And that is, fans, an onslaught.
Get in there.
Colonel Parker, he's giving instructions.
It's awfully easy to say, get in there and get him when you're standing outside there, isn't it?
Exactly, and that's what he's telling him. Got that cigar puffing down.
Yeah, there's a pit bull loose in the house, son. Get in there and get him while I stay on the back porch.
That's it, brother.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, sir, Tone. Right back to that headlock there.
Yeah, how about that?
Well, he's ragtagging him, too, with it. Got him to his knees. Oh man, if he's putting some power on that noggin, if you will.
Bunkhouse Buck trying to escape this and certainly expending a lot of energy trying to get out of it. He's out though, and now here he goes. Bunkhouse Buck doing what he knows best. And that pounding away. Didn't take long. We got a sleeper hold.
Well, he's got that thing hooked. I don't know how well he's got it hooked or what he knows about the sleeper, but he had worked on his head. I guarantee you that.
He's got something on there.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a sleeper. He's got it on.
Yeah. Well, Buck made it to the rope.
Clothesline. Buck goes over the top of the floor.
Well, Colonel Parker is irate.
Well, Colonel ought to roll in there and shake him a little bit.
Well, need to fan him up, get him back. You know, he's buying time. Even, you know, Bunkhouse Buck laying out there. As long as he keep the Renegade station there, he's okay. Look at him. Giving him some encouragement.
And the Renegade, for the first time in the match, calmly waiting. And he waved in the corner till Buck came in. And here he goes again. Well, he has one type of strategy here, and that's to yank on that head.
Yeah, as I said, he'd ragtag that old head there, and that's something different for Bunkhouse Buck to be in there and get ragtagged like that. Whoa! Yes! Hey, ref! He tripped him, Tony.
Colonel Parker tripped him, you're right, and that enables the hard-soled cowboy boots to crash against the head of Renegade.
Well, I tell you what, that's the equalizer right there, standing outside
that
ring.
You do your job, I'm not bothering you out here.
Bigfoot Renegade goes down on that one.
All right, let's see here now. Buck's strategy has changed drastically from that trip by Colonel Parker.
Now in the ring, riding like a Brahma bull. Was that your line?
No, well, you used okay. it. Yeah, my mama gonna be mad at you.
A pickup and a hard slam.
Well, at least it's all, you know. Yeah, he's going up top. This might be a mistake.
That's a big one.
Whoa. Whoa.
And that will make a buck snort.
Yes, it will.
Oh, my goodness.
That's my line, too.
Yeah, it goes.
That's good. He got both of them, man. Who's been talking to you? I'm rubbing off on Tony, man.
In the ropes. Here's the power slam. Wow.
Uh-oh. Well, he's awful far out there, Tony, if he's going for what I think he is. He's a long way across that ring.
A long way is right. If he connects, he'll hold on to the title. Oh, he did. 1, 2, 3.
Got him.
The winner of the Renegade. And we'll be back.
It is just about set to go. What was that?
Get him ready.
Yeah. Just about set to go. Yeah, just about set to go for the prime match of the week, Dream. And I tell you, congratulations, I guess, to Colonel Parker's Dirty Dick Slater and Bunkhouse Buck this past weekend. They became the world tag team champs. And Dick Slater, he is in our prime match of the week.
Well, I tell you what, prime matchup is what it's all about. That's why we talk about prime cuts. I predicted Dick Slater and Bunkhouse Buck had a shot at it. And sure enough, they have made the soothsayer, the eye of the march. Beware the American dreams. Truth come. And now we're getting ready for the prime cut match of the week. Let's all get down now.
You know, Dream, that was one of your better moves at Prime Move of the Week.
Well, I'll tell you what, this is a prime cut right here on Prime Match of the Week. Dirty Dick Slay, I'll say something about Colonel Parker. Got a lot of airtime on the Prime show this week. He's brought out his men one at a time out here trying to destroy people. And now, Dick Slater, maybe the dirtiest one of all. And I believe the key to this group right here is Dick Slater against one of the great Armstrong wrestlers.
Slater and Bunkhouse Buck, as we mentioned earlier, became World Tag Team Champions recently. And now in singles competition, here they go. Scott Armstrong, the opponent. I tell you, you know Dick Slater quite well, don't you?
Well, Dick Slater, you know, was on the good side of the law and now the bad side of the law. I tell you, you run the gamut, brother. Me and Dick Slater one time held a World Tag Team title. I'm telling you what, but he's changed his attitude running around with old Bunkhouse Buck here. Might be money. I know he loves money. But yep, he might have got a good point going for him right here. Armstrong's deep in tradition, if you will.
Deep in tradition. Side headlock. And to a head scissors. And Scott, great quickness and a man who has tremendous scientific skill. Slater is a man who possesses that scientific skill as well, but loves to kick, slap, and punch and brawl.
Well, I had got some... I got some insider people like that 900 number stuff where you call and you tell secrets and stuff.
You got so a 900 number stuff?
No, I didn't want to talk to Bunkhouse Buck, but I want to find out what he was thinking about putting these guys in single competition. And he said he liked to keep them tuned. He liked to keep them fine-tuned individually as tag team just coming off the title. He wanted to tune them. So I had like my stooge, if you will, like going back in there and everything and running back in there. And I had like Terry Taylor go and ask him, you know, how he was going to do this match, you know, and he brought that back to me. That's like 900 stuff. I'm going ahead and tell you on the air.
Terry Taylor's your stooge?
No, I just said that I had somebody go do it.
You dropped Terry's name there.
Yeah, well, he's the one I had go do it. You know,
there you go.
You know, I was.
We can put two and two together there, Dream. Back now to the corner. As you take a look at our, as always, capacity crowd on hand for WCW Prime.
KSC, the Prime Match of the Week, the big move right here, brother.
Forearm dragon twist and a return of fire by Scott Armstrong. And Scott not backing down from Dick Slater at all. A lot of courage in that youngster.
What does the big kahuna mean? Big kahuna. Like the main guy, whatever?
Yeah, the main man.
Yeah, remember the other night, the girl we were at Hunter the Beach, they kept calling me the big kahuna when you were laughing and everything. You know, we were kind of like, well, anyway.
You really want to get into this, don't you?
No, that's
I'd
all
rather
right.
Leave it alone, but you really want to get into
no,
it.
No, well, here we go. Tony Schiavone, the big kahuna right here on Prime Match of the Week.
Would you stop? Through the ropes.
Oh, look at this. A cucaracha, a cucaracha. Little hat dance on Armstrong's noggin.
And that's going to be probably the best thing that happens to him. Oh, that foot, that took some of them vertebrae and put him through the throat there.
Oh, man, he nailed him right on back the head with him cowboy boots. Got him again. Two's better than one. Oh, they get him riled. They like to get old Colonel Parker riled.
And I think that just makes his men angrier.
Well, he's got to be feeling good about himself, though. Took them titles. Sure he would.
And you think,
what?
Well, I just wondering about Colonel Parker and Sherry. Whoa!
Well, I tell you what, there's some, I believe there's a love connection there. I mean, I would love to see them on the dating game. I know for a fact that Colonel Parker locked lips with her. I know she liked it and tried to kiss him in the ear. Somebody nailed her, ended up biting half his ear off, but that wasn't the case. I believe she really liked Colonel Parker. I know he likes her.
And a sleeper hold applied by Dirty Dick Slater, and that may put Scott Armstrong out.
Well, he's going that way. He's wilting. Ooh, look at him. Look at his eyes. Look at his mouth. Look at his nose. Look at his head.
Look at his legs. They're
look
on the mat.
Legs. Rubber legs. I believe he's got him hooked in there.
I think it is over. You're right. And Randy Anderson making sure. He let him go. He let him go.
Well, he's got his back turned too. Watch out. This is it, Tony.
Scott Armstrong rolls him up.
gathered his senses and almost got a three count out of desperation. Oh, and a slam.
Oh, yes.
Telegraph that one. To the side of the head. Into the rope.
Big flush. Big drop kick.
And a cover. Scott Armstrong trying to win the match, and that's the right thing to do, fans. Remember, if you're ever in, forget it. And a yes. front chancery.
Hook him, trying to hook him up, trying to get him hooked. Got him.
A cover. 1, 2, 3. He got him.
All right, that's a big win for Dirty Dick Slater. Buck out, Buck.
Say, I think that the fact that that sleeper had a lot of effect on Scott Armstrong, even though he tried to come back, the sleeper had put him down. He was dazed and thus lost the match. With that in mind, we go to the former world champ American Dream Dusty Rhodes with a prime replay of the week.
Well, you know what I mean? There's a happy camp there with Colonel Parker and Bunkhouse Buck and Dick Slater and Steve Slater right here. You know, got him hooked up right here. You know, this, we thought this had him right here. Then he come on and double arm the arm hook and took him over. Already had him dazed, as Tony Schiavone said, from that sleep on the prime replay of the week.
The winner, one half of the World Tag Team Champs, Dirty Dick Slater. When we come back, a recap of the program and a look at an exciting program next week. You'll want to stay tuned for that when we come back. All right, fans, want to remind you that next week we will have the Macho Man Randy Savage next week here on Prime. In addition, hopefully we will find out who this new warrior is that is out to destroy Hulkamania on behalf of the Dungeon of Doom. And more talk about the upcoming match, Vader against Ric Flair and Arn Anderson in a handicap match.
I tell you what, Tony, though, what I'm looking forward to is taking a good, hard, cold look at Bunkhouse Buck and Dick Slater against the Nasty Boys. They gonna like to prime up next week, and I can't wait. Macho Man Randy Savage, domination of the Nature Boy Ric Flair. What does Ric Flair now play into this whole situation? We might find out on the Prime.
Fans, come on back with us next week for the American Dream. Dusty Rhodes, Tony Schiavone. See you next week on Prime.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to WCW Prime. I'm Chris Cruz, and this is the American Dream. Dusty Rhodes, smiling as always. What is so funny?
I'll tell you what, Chris, you know, we have one on a star search. WCW Prime has gotten so hot with the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, they saying you need somebody flamboyant, somebody that wears a bow tie, somebody that can bring this thing home. Get that Tony Schiavone off here and bring the silver tongue Chris Cruz right with you on WCW Prime, the top-rated wrestling program in the world. Here he is, Christopher Bow Ties Cruz. Tell him what we're going to do today, Chris.
What we're going to do today is see the Renegade in action, the world television champion. Also, Shark and Kamala and Dusty, the Nasty Boys take on Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater, the world tag team champs. You predicted they'd win the belt.
Slater and Buck, let's do it.
Oh, that's all you're going to say about
that's
Slater.
It.
And Big Bubba in the Prime match. Now, we take you to the ring here on WCW Prime with the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Oh, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 235 pounds, Macho Man, Randy Savage!
Well, Dusty, I thank you for that ebullient welcome. I didn't expect to be so warmly welcomed with such open arms from the American Dream.
Well, I tell you what, Chris, you talk about a warm welcome here on WCW Prime. One of the most stirring entrances in WCW is Randy, the Macho Man Randy Savage, and really on top of his game after the dominance over Ric Flair at Bash at the Beach.
You liked that match, didn't you?
I loved it.
I bet you did. All right, now to his opponent,
this
Macho Man's opponent.
Sicily, weighing 237 pounds, Dino Casanova.
All right, Dino Casanova.
Dino looked like he's right out of one of them Godfather movies, you know what I mean? He looked like he's right from Italy, and one of them guys that would just... Maybe how they used to say when they would say, I'm going to put a contract on somebody. He might be putting a contract on the Macho Man Randy Savage right here.
Well, I got to tell you, Dusty, you know, Macho Man, a guy who has a lot of sizzle, a lot of charisma, but there's also a lot of stake there. When this guy puts it together, when he's got his wrestling boots on, as they say, just about unbeatable and certainly nonstop. against a guy like Fino Casanova.
Well, what a crowd we got here at WCW Prime. And I guarantee you, my man Chris Cruz, Silver Tongue, if you will, the Macho Man Randy Savage, is fine on him, and I cannot wait for this program to get on into it, because we got some heavy stuff today. Whoa,
well, Casanova getting into it. Just, that's right. He just dumped Randy Macho Man Savage outside the ring. Looks like he's not at all impressed by the reputation of the former world heavyweight champion.
Well, one thing is, you don't want to get him riled, because if you get Macho Man Randy Savage riled, that's what happens to you. Start fisticuffs on your noggin.
This is one of the nicest guys you ever want to meet, is Randy Macho Man Savage. But don't cross him, because he'll do what he's doing right now to Dino Casanova. Man, did you see that neck snap back? And look out, Dusty. You've seen this so many times before. He's up on the top rope, and he is going to drop that elbow. Kablam! There it is.
Boy, he nailed it from the top. Referee's down, got the 1-2-3. The Macho Man Randy Savage high flying off the top. And you talk about kicking our program off. Chris Cruz, welcome to WCW Prime. Ain't nothing like it.
They sure ain't. That's the Randy Macho Man Savage. Randy the Macho Man Savage, I beg your pardon, gives the thumbs up to the crowd, and they give it right back to him. This guy is loved by the fans watching here in WCW Prime.
Well, right here, he drops his throat across there, and he bounces back about 150 yards. And the Macho Man comes from way up top the building. Gets the cover on a 1-2-3 and going to step up to the pay window, Chris. Because he's making a lot of money like me and you for WCW Prime.
And still coming up here on WCW Prime, the Swedish Olympic champion, Frank Anderson. And welcome back, fans, to WCW Prime Wrestling. Chris Cruz and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And we're about to see the Swedish Dream, the Swedish version of Dusty Rhodes. This guy, a former Olympic champion, and Dusty, a national hero in Sweden. He can't walk the streets without being mobbed in Stockholm.
Well, I heard that in Stockholm, he cannot walk. I have walked the streets in Stockholm before, and it was at night. And I know there's a lot. Well, I don't want to get into that, because my mama's listening out in Houston of what goes on when I walk the streets down in Stockholm. But he has all the tools, bringing an amateur background into a pro atmosphere. He has yet, though, really, Chris, to step up to the plate against somebody that has the ability that I want to see him against. You know what I mean? Much like the pit bulldog Pittman.
Yes,
you know what I mean?
Yes.
Great amateur background, but got to step up to the plate. Right here, he's in with a veteran, but not what I want to see him doing.
A great hip lock takeover and a second one there by Frank Anderson. You're right. What a match that would be against two great amateurs, Craig the Pitbull Pittman. And Anderson's, it looks like, one of his weaknesses, Dusty, and I know you pointed this out before, is his hesitation. He is backing up instead of going forward.
Yeah, and the other weakness is color coordination. If you would look at his tights, he looks like the peacock at NBC. You know what I mean? The color coordination is another weakness of his, but I'm sure he'll work that out. Nice. He late sweeping.
He sure did.
That was the old schoolboy. When you played marbles, you went up behind a guy that was beating you and swept his legs out. And then he yells at him. Must have... What?
I think Chris Sawyer is saying that, well, maybe he doesn't like the fact that Frank Anderson took advantage. And that's exactly what Anderson did. The mark of an excellent wrestler is using your opponent's weaknesses as well as your strengths. And a couple of solid rights that rocked the former Olympic champion.
Well, he did a good job there getting a little game plan going for him. Got him in a headlock trying to control him. You don't want him jumping around like a jumping bean like he does, you know what I mean? Getting some of them holds on you, them double leg lip locks and all that stuff, you know, getting you down where you can't get out. You need to stay in control of the situation.
A double leg lip lock?
Well, you know, that's when you got a guy by both legs and you bite him on the thigh or something, you know, and make him, you know, pain, blues, and agony comes into him.
All right, Chris Sawyer looking a lot the worse for wear there against Frank Anderson, who seems to be now in a forward-moving position. He's just backed out of the corner there by Sawyer, who is, as you pointed out, Dusty, a veteran. Right into the full Nelson, a move we see very rarely nowadays, a modified version of the Fireman's Carry Takeover, right into the arm bar there by Frank Anderson.
Yep.
Over more than 20 years at the highest levels of this sport, Dusty, I know that you have known many amateur wrestlers who thought they could make it big in professional wrestling. The fact is, very few of them do.
No, but a lot of them don't have the credentials he has either. A lot of them are great amateurs, and they were, you know, they have Olympians, some of them. And I've seen some great Olympians, come through and really make their mark. But I still say, until I see him tested
with guys like Vader, or tested with guys like Ron the Harlem Heat, or Bert the Harlem Heat, or tested with guys like Bunkhouse Buck and Dick Slater, or tested with guys that have really, if you say, went to school of hard knocks, if you will, then I think he has the tools, but then we'll find out. That's a nice move.
That's right. One, two, a nice gut-wrench suplex there by Anderson, who had to power over Chris Sawyer, who has that low center of gravity.
Oh,
and a solid right, and another one right on the ear, maybe affecting the balance of the Olympian.
Get him right on the temple there, get his equilibrium off.
Oh, and Sawyer unwisely runs right in. Oh, a spinning reverse kick.
Kicked him right in the belly well. It got him down right there. I'm telling you, got him right in the belly well.
Look at the lower abdomen. Look at this belly to belly over the top. Hooks up the arm and the neck and gets the 1-2-3. A nice win for the ever-improving Frank Anderson.
He just winked at you. Did you see that?
That wasn't at me. I think
yes,
he was winking
was.
At his face. All right, and we're coming back with more action here on WCW Prime featuring the World Television Champion.
Why did you wink at you, Tom?
And you hear that music, and you're about to see the charismatic World Television Champion come screaming out to the ring. Dusty, here comes the Renegade. There he is.
Well, I talk about movement and different athletes. This guy's constant motion. The only way to beat him is to slow him down, and nobody has yet been able to do that. He is constant movement, as you see, running around the ring. He's one of them guys that could, you know, beat himself into the bed when he turned the light switch before the light went out. He is that quick. He has that ability.
That is quick. I never heard it put quite so succinctly.
Yeah, and he's in there with that red-headed stepchild.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you what, he better be ready because that kid will have attacked him right off the bat.
I really like that Bobby Starr. He's kind of like an insect, kind of like a mosquito. A small guy, but he's just so irritating. And the Renegade, without a whole lot of experience against a guy like Bobby Starr, I guess decides to just go running after him.
And the Renegade's on, and here comes right up the back. Watch out, brother. They were running around there like they were there.
Oh.
Yeah, that hung him up.
Whoa, that hung him up. Another one. And Bobby Starr pops up. Oh, man.
Well, the momentum is like a rubber ball. If you throw a ball on the mat, it pops back up to you. And Bobby Starr was, landing on his caboose. Look at this.
Oh, what athleticism from a man of his size. Nearly 260 pounds. Now the whip into the rope. A power slam. That should do it. That should do it for the World Television Champion, I guess. No, wait a minute.
Well, he barraged him right here. Look at this now.
Wait,
I'm
going to
tell
minute.
You what. Look how far Bobby Starr is laying out there in the middle of the ring. Must be a half a football league field length over there. Up to the top. Look at this. He hooked it.
And he hooks the leg, and Starr had no chance against the Renegade, the World Television Champion. Jimmy Hart has brought this guy to the top in such a very short time, Dusty. I can't remember the last time that somebody of this gentleman's level of experience has achieved such great success. Let's take a look at that again.
Well, right here, you see him here, a little flip-flop. I used to do this on my way to the bathroom. And then right there, he nailed that red-headed kid, got him all down there discombobulated. And right here, as he throws him in, look at this big old power slam. And then high top to big top. The Renegade goes all the way to a top. Half a football league field lands on top of him. Gets the 1-2-3 Renegade to the pay window.
And there's more action to come, including the Shark and Kamala. We'll also see Bunkhouse Buck, Dirty Dick Slater against the Nasty Boys, and a whole lot more when WCW Prime continues in a moment.
He winked at you.
Hi again, folks. Gene Okerlund reminding you that this Clash of the Champions report is brought to you by Slim Jim. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim. This Sunday night, live from Daytona Beach, FLA, it's the Clash of the Champions. Check your local listings for time and channel. At Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions, you'll see one man, 452-pound Big Van Vader, square off against two men, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, in a special handicap match. If that's the war to settle the score, then here's the brawl to settle it all. A special six-man tag. On one side, tag team champions Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater, along with their manager, Colonel Robert Parker. On the other side, the Harlem Heat and Sister Sherry. You heard me right. Five men and a woman.
plus world television champ Renegade with a very capable Jimmy Hart in his corner, defends against Slim Jim Challenge winner, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. In addition, new U.S. champ Sting teams up with Road Warrior Hawk. They're going to be meeting Ming and his new partner, Kurosawa, in what should be an extraordinary tag team matchup. You know about the challenge on the table for WCW Heavyweight Champion Hulk Hogan. That challenge coming from the Dungeon of Doom. Hopefully, we're going to hear more about that later this weekend. Plus, a special feature at the Clash on the Macho Man, Randy Savage. It all happens this Sunday, live from Daytona Beach. It's Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions. Fans, a reminder, WCW once again is setting the standard in wrestling. And in keeping with that, we're excited to present Collision in Korea, exclusively on pay-per-view, Friday, August the 4th. Over 300,000 fans on hand as WCW and New Japan brought pro wrestling to North Korea. Available Friday, August 4th, only on pay-per-view.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. Your judge, jury, and executioner. Judge Dredd is now available for all major video game systems from Acclaim. Take the law into your own hands.
We're getting very, very sleepy,
Now step out of it! It's Devin Old Beefy Spicy Slim Jim, oh yeah!
Attention citizens, be on the lookout for Judge Dredd Mean Machine and all the Judge Dredd action figures. There's a battle for justice in every action pack. Judge Dredd, pack sold differently.
Hurry, my son, get away from the stove. The real white finger tiger approaches. The bait has been set. Hurry!
My father, I smell his presence also.
I feel him.
Where am I? There's no Hulkamaniacs here. I've never been here before. It's not hot. What is this place? I know you. I know you too. You two are behind the demise of Hulkamania. I know about the Zodiac. I know about the dangerous Kamala. Hell yeah. I know about the Man-Eater. The Shark! But Instinct Stone is a legacy, the immortality of Hulkamania! And you too will be buried beneath it!
You don't understand! Hogan! This is where darkness dwells and lives! Nobody has ever been able to defeat the immortal Hulk Hogan, except yourself. You see, Hogan, you're the one that created me. And because of that, it's invisible. Your demise is instant.
My power is a million times greater than the power of Hulkamania. I am the greatest giant who ever walked the face of the earth. And I am the one true immortal.
Fans coast to coast in front of a live national television audience, the Clash of the Champions, Sunday, August the 6th. Check your local listing for time and station. A couple of gentlemen who may be in a bit of a pickle joining me at this time, the 11th, make that 12 time. WCW Heavyweight Champ of the World, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Enforcer Arn Anderson, you know you're signed to meet Vader, 452 pounds of Big Van Vader. And I get the impression the two of you are kind of laughing this deal off in a handicap.
Well, you know, Gene, I know where Vader's from in Colorado up on that mountain. The air's real thin. Makes you do crazy things. make rash decisions. But Vader, understand one thing. This is not an action-adventure movie. This is not Stallone, Schwarzenegger, Steven Seagal, where one guy will take out 5, 10, 25 guys. This is the real deal. I've sat in locker rooms and looked across the ring and saw guys sitting there shivering, shaking, puking in a garbage can, thinking about the thought of wrestling myself individually, or Ric Flair. And then you think collectively, well, then you figure, well, okay, I'll go for a quick kill. Quick kill. It's hot in Daytona. Quick kill. What happens if you don't get that quick kill, which you won't? We're going to run you and run you and run you till that tongue falls out, and then we're going to jump on you like a pack of wild dogs.
Paints quite a picture.
We're not going to make you pay the price, fat boy. You understand what I'm telling you? Two, I guess one, you want to wrestle the Enforcer and the Nature Boy? Two, I guess one, who do you think you are? The insult to breathe that to me makes me incensed, makes me wild. Two against one, big boy, this side of life is going to change for you, pal. He's made him bleed, and I've made him sweat. And side by side, Clash of Champions, you belong to us.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
Vader.
And we're back, Chris Cruz and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And Dusty, we're about to see one of the biggest tag teams in, well, in professional wrestling history, I think.
But I tell you what, they come right out of the dungeon and do it. You see that? They transpired. We cast with a tap message on all these guys in the dungeon and do. And, well, what a great update when we're talking about Clash of Champions, Tennessee televised. That's going to be something, that big handicap match, if you will, with Vader, Major Boy Ric Flair, and Arn Anderson. But what we got here at hand is a guy that is wearing this ceremonial headpiece. We got a guy with a shark tooth that's bigger than Jaws. They both weigh 9 million pounds. And they got a guy there that is an idiot, complete crazy man.
As Terry Morgan and Tom Torres are the heretofore unnamed opponents of the Shark and Kamala. Coming up on the Clash of Champions on national television, you mentioned, Dusty, the Dungeon of Doom. Will Hulk Hogan accept the challenge and enter the Dungeon of Doom? He's already agreed, in fact, demanded on the main event program to air before the Clash of the Champions to beat one of the members of the Dungeon of Doom.
Well, a nationally televised audience will take a look at that thing at the Clash of Champions on August 6th. Bottom line right here, the old shark is in there now. Oh, the shark by put it too well. And to keep him pearly round. When I'm sticking around the corner, will my name be Mac tonight? See, there he is.
That's Terry Morgan, and he wishes he could be singing in the shower right now. That's where he's headed very shortly, I would imagine. Look out. Now, the shark is going to... What is he doing? Oh, some Mac.
What?
Some Mac.
Some Mac. Man, that's almost like a rodent. Some Mac. Look at this.
You mean it's already bleeding over?
Look at this confrontation. Oh, he just said it. You hear what he said?
All he said was Hulkamania.
Yeah, you caught that. Everybody caught that.
That's all he needed to say, and Kamala all of a sudden got focused.
Hey, look in that aisle way up there. That girl can't find a seat. See how crowded it is here at WCW? Can't even find that seat, man. Can you believe that?
You're right.
We got the best seat in the house.
If you look around here, the fans watching WCW Prime, there's not an empty seat in the house. It is jam-packed. Oh, look at that reverse thrust kick there by the Ugandan warrior.
Ugandan warrior it is, I'm telling you. I told the people before, I'd seen this guy over there in Uganda. I was on a Naga hide hunt over there, and I had a bunch of big game buys and everything.
A what?
Naga hide, hunting Naga hide. Look at this shot. He just slung him in there.
He's short. Oh, Tom Torres. He's got no chance at all against the Ugandan warrior. Oh, look at that chop. He does it again, and a choke.
Blatant. In the words of the immortal God and Soli, a blatant chokehold.
Yes.
And blatant must mean like everybody can see it.
And we sure could, including everybody watching here on Prime. Oh, look, poor Tom Torres is just rammed headfirst into the mass that is called Shark. Well over 500 pounds, Kamala. Nearly 400 pounds.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, he is. Since the taskmaster said to him, Hulkamania Hulk Hogan, he come a running in there and just taking care of business.
At this point, what role will the Dungeon of Doom play in the end of Hulkamania? They think that they will play the leading role. Oh, look at that chop.
And the final role.
Yes.
The final role, brother. Well, speaking of roles, Kamala got a couple roles there, brother.
I knew that was coming. Either that or he's been eating a lot of roles, right?
You know, for his size, though, Chris, he is so agile and powerful. You see that? And he can move like a cat. I'm telling you, he is a dangerous man. And he's flashy. If you're turned over, if you're sitting up, don't matter. Look at that. Made a tag. That's nice.
And what a gentle tag for two vicious big men. In comes the shark. He keeps adjusting that ominous. Oh, look out! The shark attack. That's going to do it. One, two, and three. And Tom Torres and Terry Morgan, as you said, Dusty, never had a chance.
Well, that thing was over before it started. I mean, they just jumped in there through the fire and the shark, and Kamala take a victory. And I guarantee you one thing, Hulkamania got to be worried about this situation with the Dungeon of Doom.
And still to come, Bunkhouse Buck, Dirty Dick Slater against the Nasty Boys here on WCW Prime.
Feature contest tag team action is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Colonel Robert Parker from Bucksport, Tennessee, Bunkhouse Buck. His tag team partner from Port Tampa, Florida, Dirty Dick Slater.
And Dusty, they are so proud of having defeated the Harlem Heat to become the new world tag team champions.
Well, I tell you what, they had a victory party in Bucksport, Tennessee. I know. I was invited. I'm going to tell you what, I did not go because I don't like Colonel Parker, but I hear that whole town turned out, all three or four of them, all the family were there, and all the pigs were lining the street, and all them old hogs that had flopped down that Bucksnot.
This is just a little warm what? Up for Buck and Dick, getting them ready for the World Tag Team Championship.
Wait a minute. You got an invitation?
Yes, I got an invitation. Did you get one?
It must have been lost in the mail or something.
Well, I imagine it was, although I can understand that they might not send you one because, I won't even get into that. But they will after they see the prime.
Oh, absolutely. You're being sincere with me, aren't you?
Yes.
All right, here come their opponents, and look out for the Nasty Boys.
Their opponents from the streets of New York City, as nasty as they want to be.
Do you know that on three separate occasions, Sags and Knobs, the Nasty Boys, have been World Tag Team Champions?
Well, Chris, it's very simple. There was a triangle match at the Bash of the Beach. The situation was that Bunkhouse Buck and Dick Slater were left out of it. Did they train? Did they spend that time really concentrating on what they were doing to beat the Harlem Heat? Because they had that match coming up. We knew that. So I had said, Nasty Boys, Harlem Heat, the Blue Blood, of them three right there, two had tasted the World Tag Team title. And now then, they are all chasing who? They're chasing Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater. And the Nasty Boys, they don't take no prisoners, I'm telling you. This is going to be fast and furious. So put a bolt, put your butt down on that chair, and get ready for lightning bolts to strike in this building.
They got to loosen my bow tie.
Oh, man, that's the honkiest thing I've ever seen. But I'm going to see how my mama reacts to it. She always calls me after the show.
All right.
And if she likes it, we're going to go ahead and keep it in. If she don't, we got to take that thing off, man.
Well, you know, Bunkhouse Buck, Dirty Dick Slater are going to be teaming up with Colonel Parker at the Clash. And they're going to be facing the Harlem Heat and Sister Sherry. What are we saying here? We're going to see Sister Sherry fight Colonel Parker?
Well, we're saying Sister Sherry is one of the toughest men in wrestling. And I will say that. She got a face that will stop a clock. You can put her out in the field somewhere with her watermelons and stuff, and she could be like a scarecrow and stand out there. There won't be a bird one flying that field out there. But I'm going to tell you what, the knowledge she has for Harlem Heat has really made them a real power. But right here, the problem that Slater and Buck has is the Nasty Boys, because they don't want to go to Peter City. They don't want to get their face stuck in that no deodorant armpit of the Nasty Boys.
It's nasty time. That is Brian Knobs. These guys both pushing about 300 pounds. And they are just ready for Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater. They want the World Tag Team belt back.
Well, I guarantee you, fans, we will see some clubbering in this match here. Four fists on one guy. These guys are all clubberers right here. And look at that mug. Look at that mug on him.
What's with that hair thing anyway? Colonel Parker waving that handkerchief. Well, he's concerned. You know, the more he waves, the more concerned.
Yeah, you being authority on hair, we got to remember that you are not just the client, you're the president.
I thank you very much for pointing that out. Oh, look at the stomps there from Buckhouse Buck.
There you go. That's what you got to do to net the boy.
Yeah. Dish out the nastiness before they dish it out on you. Whoa, a back body drop and Bunkhouse Buck. Well, that's enough of the offense from him. And Dick Slater, wow, a lariat on both of them. Watch this.
Just hit somebody. You know what I mean? Look at this.
Uh-oh, indeed. Oh.
Yes.
The referee's head was turned and Sags dropped his head. And that was it. Here comes the Pity City Dust.
Yeah, and I think that was a little low blow, but I was not in there to call it. Yeah, he didn't want no part of that Pity City. See there? As soon as he raised his arm and the folk rushed out of that armpit, Slater was gone. Slater need to regroup this team right here now.
All right, there's the lanky Bunkhouse Buck at Dick Slater. He looks almost, well, he is in pain. He looks almost like he's crying, but Dick Slater, legitimately one of the toughest guys in professional wrestling. Don't ever count that man out.
Well, that's four tough hombres in there. Yeah. I ain't saying much about Colonel Park out there. Got a great brain. I mean, he brought the world tag team title, these guys right here.
Colonel Parker. Well, Colonel Parker said that he would bring them to the World Tag Team Championship. He said, gentlemen, or fellas, stick with me, I'll bring you to the top. He was right.
You know what he was doing out there? He was on a filibuster. And that was just killing time when you filibuster and everything like on Congress floor.
Yeah.
That's what he was doing to get their breath back. But they're in the wrong corner. Clubbing! There's Clubbing right there. I see it. You see it, Chris?
I saw it.
That was a prime example of four-fisted on one guy, and that was some serious Clubbing.
I like that. A prime on the prime. Some what?
Big cut Clubbing.
Yeah, that's what I thought you said. Oh, right from the eyes. You're pushing it, Dusty Rhodes. You're pushing it.
Well, Rick Fetchett, you know, my producer is so great. I hear he's up for one of them Chloe's, or what do you call them things? Emmys. Cable.
Oh.
Yeah,
Aces. Yeah.
Oh,
a nice suplex. All right, we're getting word that we're going to have to take a very quick commercial break.
You kidding?
Yes, the tape machines will continue to run.
I ain't leaving.
Me neither. And if anything happens, we'll replay it as soon as we get back from this commercial break. Nasty Boys against Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater. Don't go away. All right, we're back here on WCW Prime. It's the Nasty Boys squaring off against the new World Tag Team Champions, Bunkhouse Buck, and that man, Dirty Dick Slater. Chris Cruz, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, calling the action here on Prime. And Dusty, the collar and elbow tie up, and Slater backs up Brian Knobb.
Well, Slater, you know, they regrouped while we were gone. They had to, because they were in the stump of the mud hole in Colonel Parker. Right now, boy, I'm going to tell you what, they're exchanging blows right here.
A pull of a hair there on Dick Slater. That's one way to get it done. Whoa! A double shoulder block. They lower those shoulders and ram them into Dirty Dick Slater with tremendous power.
Well, they need to regroup. Colonel Parker tried, and we were gone in the way. There was so much action going on that they had tried to regroup right then and right here. Slater really needs to get this thing and try to sell it back down, because that's the ball on a real roll here.
They absolutely are. They're the ones who are chasing the World Tag Team Champions again in the background. You see Dick Slater, who is in a tremendous amount of pain, and hey, who wouldn't be? Look at this guy. I mean, after getting a clubbering from these guys, I'd be in tremendous pain for the rest of my life.
He's doing a little dance right there, you know. He's so excited. They're so excitable, the Nasty Boys. I never seen two guys that were so excitable like they are. They'll fight at a drop of a hat, and they're in there with two guys that will fight also.
Absolutely.
At a drop of a hat.
The collar and elbow tie-up, and Sags backs in Bunkhouse Buck. That was somewhat of an unorthodox tag, but it worked. And a straight right to the gut, and a straight right to the head. Oh, and a forearm smash to the head. That'll wake you up. Ooh, look at the drop of the elbow there by Knobs.
Well, somehow here, they need to turn this thing around because,
Knob says, I'm going to get the lariat on Bunkhouse Buck. Buck gets up. Oh, baby.
Hello,
goodness. And Knobs, unfortunately for him, after a chop there from Slater, unfortunately for him, he went out the wrong side, right over the top rope. Sags is being chased by the referee. This has broken down, and all of a sudden, Slater and Bunkhouse Buck are in charge.
Well, we talked about making crucial mistakes, and the first team that made a real crucial mistake would be in dire straits, and the Nasty Boys have made that mistake. You know, he had Knobs and Sags. I mean, Knobs was flying out of there, brother, right in your living room like you had on a pad of 3D glasses. There he was, laying in your lap.
Oh, it's a calving rope.
A what?
Bunkhouse Buck's cap. I said it's a calving rope.
A calving rope? Are you crazy?
Isn't that what they use to lasso calves?
You've been in San Francisco too long. That ain't no calving rope.
I haven't been in San Francisco.
That's a pig and string. That's a calving rope. My goodness.
Well, what do I know?
Hey, Rick. I'm gonna try to get home my producer and see what Gordon Soley's doing. I cannot believe this. A calving rope.
Oh, and you think Gordon Soley would know what it is?
He dang sure would.
Oh, all right.
Man, I'm gonna let that thing slide. I mean a calving rope. He choked him with a calving rope and he hit it with his pantyhose. What are we talking about here? My goodness, come on.
Hey, will you lay off? I made a mistake.
All right. I see what I've got that we're gonna do. Anyway.
Oh, a swinging neck breaker.
A swinging neck breaker.
From Dirty Dick Slater.
There you go. We're getting back in it.
We're getting back in it, and that's an elbow. I think I called that one right.
Well, you called them all right. It just kind of, I kind of got out of hand with the captain rope.
All right, and Slater, one half now, the World Tag Team Championships.
Oh, man.
Oh, look at that. He tags in Bunkhouse Buck, and Bunkhouse Buck tags Brian Knopf.
Well, they're doing what they need to do now. They're keeping him over there in this side of the territory, and they're biting him. They are kicking him. They are punching him in the belly welly. They are kicking him in other places that you shouldn't, and they're taking control of it. Oh, well, hello.
Hello, foot.
Yes, look at that. Blatted him like a pancake.
It sure did. It looks like Bunkhouse can tag Dirty Dick Slater, yes. He's got enough energy. Slater. Oh, he caught Jerry Sags.
That's a
Sags
good move.
Wants to come in. It was a great move. You're right.
Because the referee got to get him out. He done committed.
All right. There's Knobs in there against Slater. A suplex.
Oh, got to roll over and cover him. This might be it, Chris.
Here comes one, two, no. A combined roll out and a kick out there by Brian Knobs. And look at that. A couple of fistfuls of hair. Look out. Oh. Right in the nose. Here comes the cover. One, two, and a kick out again by Knobs.
Nice tag. Quick tag to in and out. That's what they knew. Keep the fresh man in there and just put the power and moves on him right here.
Oh, a double blow to the top of the head. The Nasty Boys know this is high stakes. This match, very important. They know if they can defeat Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater, they will be in line for a shot, a title shot, at the World Tag Team Championships.
Well, he's firing back right here. He needs to get over and make that tag, get the fresh man in. Nasty Boys need to make a tag, but... Oh, they're so close. Look at this. Both arms out. Slater got it.
Haven't they tagged? No, they are literally inches away. Oh, an elbow right on the back of the neck. There's no way to protect against that. Man, oh man, this has been absolutely brutal. If he gets the pile driver, if Slater gets the pile driver on Knobs, this one is all over. Well, Knobs, yes, Knobs is able to reverse it. Oh, and he sits on him.
Whoa, he took his buckets and sit right in his belly willy.
Oh, brother, that was 20 pounds of lard sitting down there.
What a tag that is.
I hope you never taught anatomy and physiology.
Whoa, who? No, but I wrestled both in front.
No, we'll come back to that later. And Sags, he's all on fire. He whips Dirty Dick Slater. Oh, hilarious there. A straight right on Bunkhouse Buck. Sags will fight anybody. Oh, another lariat.
Well, he's a fresh man. He needs to go ahead and take him to school right here. Uh-oh, got his eyes raped.
It sure did, and look out, Sags now is being double-teamed by Dirty Dick Slater, and Bunkhouse Buck, he tags, no! He hangs onto the rope, and then a double clothesline on Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater.
He might be going for it here, he needs to, I tell you, he's the fresh other two, but here comes, tagged his partner, hey, what is that?
We're a good 12 minutes into this match, both teams.
What was that? Did you see that?
That was a cowboy boot.
That wasn't a capping boot?
That wasn't a capping boot. That was a cowboy boot. What is going on here? Oh, what's going on?
They sent him up right here for the blivet right off the top.
The nasty death drop. All right, here it comes.
The blivet.
The blivet, too. Kaboom.
That's it.
He just bliveted.
Yes.
Here comes the 1, 2, 3. Come on, referee, turn around. Here it is. 1, 2.
Yes. And he's got the capping boot and going to town on him with it.
We're out of time. We'll be back with the WCW Prime match in a moment.
Wow.
Oh.
Dusty, I don't think anybody looks forward more to the prime match of the week than you do. It involves Big Bubba.
Well, you know, when we talk about the prime cut match of the week, that's one of the reasons your letter interested me when it was wrote in about being announcer with me here on WCW Prime. And I went through all the lists of De Niro and all these guys out there, Cruz, and people that wanted this thing that they knew Tony just couldn't handle. You know what I'm talking about? And I said, I'm going to take Chris Cruz because he loved the prime cut match of the week. We got a great one, and I'm going to tell you, I'm going to give you your first taste of this one. This is how good this one is. All the girls get out the way and let the bulls in here.
Big Bubba against Mark Starr. It's our WCW prime cut match of the week. And here we go. More than 300 pounds, Dusty, and this guy moves like a lightweight, one of the most dangerous athletes in world championship wrestling, and what an attitude, and I don't mean a good one. Here's Big Bubba.
Well, you talk about the prime match. You want a great prime match right here. This guy is the one that can do it to it right here. The speed and agility for the size that this man possesses, as you said, is unmatched by anybody in WCW.
This guy, and I think you might agree, Dusty, just goes out looking for a fight in life as well as in the wrestling ring. That's Mark Starr. Mark is a product of the WCW training school that we call the Power Plant. He is one of the rising, hopes to be one of the rising young stars here in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, he's got a lot of ability. I really like his get, so he really needs to come in there with a game plan. And a lot of these youngsters that come in, they don't have it. But with Bubba, you know one thing, when you get him a shaking and a baking like he is, you got to make him miss a lot of times, because if he gets you one time, the rest of the match, you're just going to be right there. You got to bounce up. There you go. Don't be down where he can get you again. Great move by Mark Starr. Bounce right up. WCW Prime right here with Chris Cruz doing a great job here, except for the cap and rope.
You're never going to let me forget that. Hey, look at that. Mark Starr, his hair pulled, and he was slammed back into the... Oh,
whoa.
What was that?
He caught him right in the eye, brother, with that heel of his hand.
Now the whip, oh man, what a lariat that was. I hate to admit it, Dusty, but there are some fans who actually cheer for Big Bubba. It kind of scares me, but some people like what he does.
Well, you know what, ladies love outlaws. You know that? A lot of fans love outlaws, brother. Good and the bad. WCW, we got it all. You can pick who you like. That's what's so great about Prime. Pick who you like and take them on home if you can.
Big Bubba spends a lot of time talking to the referee, talking to the opponent, talking to the fans, never in a respectful way. There's Mark Starr with no respect for Big Bubba.
Look at that. Yes, come on, Mark. Fire up, baby.
Starr about 6'2", 240 pounds. He's whipped there by Big Bubba. Goes for the sunset flip. He's got him over. One, two, oh, what an upset.
Wow, what an upset is right. Man, don't make a mistake, kid.
Ha. Oh, no, look out.
Oh, man.
The slam. Some people call that a sidewalk slam.
What?
A sidewalk slam.
A sidewalk slam.
Sideways, sidewalk, whatever you want to call it, Big Bubba can do it. And he has almost incapacitated this big young man named Mark Starr.
Going to work in the injured part of your body. That's what it's all about. That back right there. Look at this shot here. Whoa!
Oh, man. Star oblivious at this point, and here's the athleticism we talked about. An uppercut, and Mark Starr is laid out, and Big Bubba is very satisfied with himself.
Well, this is a really prime look at Big Bubba. He's having a prime match right here. I've never seen him look so good. He's really rallying.
This, of course, our prime match of the week. Big Bubba, what is he? We expecting to find an S there on his chest? I don't know what he was trying to do there. Oh, and just stepped on the throat of Mark Starr.
What?
Hey, little man.
He's talking to you.
He's talking
that?
To you.
No, he says, don't call me little man.
No.
You know that I'll jump up there and do something in his head.
Now the whip. Oh, look out. The side scoop slam. We call that the Bubba slam.
Bubba slam is right. Big Bubba's got him too, I believe. Got him hooked up right here. That's it.
Just put one hand on and said, I have defeated you, Mark Starr. Like, frankly, he's defeated a whole lot of his opponents. What is this? So, wants to get those shades back on.
It ain't nothing but a thing. Bottom line is, I can beat any man, any given time, just because I'm big enough, and just because I'm jammed.
Wow. because he's strong enough and mean enough to fog up our camera. Let's take a look now at the Prime Replay, Dusty.
All righty, the big Prime Replay. What an action-packed Prime matchup this was right here. And this Prime Replay, he caught him here with a lariat, as you said, and then he took his head off, had him out on his feet right here, and he picks him up in this Bubba Slam. Yeah. And he gets that 1-2-3 on him. That's the Prime Replay of the week on this Prime matchup. And what are we going to do next? What are we doing?
We're going to talk about Big Bubba and how at nearly 300 pounds, he has the athletic movement of somebody 100 pounds lighter. This guy, well, that's frankly why he is so devastating.
No, I didn't mean that. I mean, where are we going now?
What we're going to do is we're going to take a break, and then you and I will come back with some closing comments about this week's WCW Prime. Well, Dusty, sad to say, we are out of time for this week's WCW Prime, but next week, as we promised, Diamond Ellis Page against Dave Sullivan.
Well, I tell you what, the networks across the country, the WCW Prime and the Prime Network, were so happy with my choice right here on this great show. We had a great show today.
Yeah.
But we talk about wrestling at its best, WCW Prime next week, Diamond Dallas Page, Dave Sullivan, and I cannot wait to see that Ugandan animal. The Ugandan, what do they call him? Ugandan
warrior.
Warrior, yes, because he has the taskmaster with him and bring his drums and all them hula girls from Uganda. I cannot wait.
Also, the Harlem Heat, Johnny B. Bad, Marcus Alexander, Bagwell, and a whole lot more. Fans, see you next week on the Prime.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.